आपण एक मीटिंग आपण घेतली होती तेव्हा बऱ्याच डॉक्टरांना ह्याच्यात येता नाही आलं, त्यामुळे आत्ताची मीटिंग आपली खूप अगदी वेळेवर ठरलेली आहे, दुपारी ठरली आहे, आणि त्यामुळे बहुतेकांना कदाचित अजून मेसेज गेले नसतील. आता मेसेज जात आहेत आणि लोक ऍड होत आहेत. मी सर्वांचं स्वागत करते आणि निमा चे डॉक्टर बाजारी आहेत, डॉक्टर लोंढेजी आहेत आणि डॉक्टर दागाजी आहेत, ह्यांचे पण आभार व्यक्त करते. अतिशय अर्जंट आपण हे ठरवलं, कारण पुढच्या रविवारपर्यंत ढकललं असतं तर खूप वेळ झाला असता आणि हे आवश्यक आहे. मी स्वतः मागचे 5 महिने मिथिलिन ब्ल्यू घेत आहे आणि आता सुद्धा मी एका कोविड सेंटरला भेट देऊन आली, क्वारंटाईन सेंटरमध्ये सुद्धा आज व्हिजिट होती. तर मी तिथून आले आणि लगेच हे आपण पाहत आहे, नेब्युलायझर माझ्या टेबलावरच असतं. आलं की आम्ही नेब्युलायझरवरती मिथिलिन ब्ल्यू टाकतो, मी आणि माझी मुलगी दोघी. ती सुद्धा KM मध्ये आता तिची पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएशन म्हणून ड्युटी लागलेली आहे आणि हे मिथिलिन ब्ल्यू सुद्धा टेबलवरच असतं. त्यामुळे एक मला एक समाधान आहे आणि मी 5 महिन्यात ह्याचे इफेक्ट्स पाहिलेले आहेत आणि माझे जवळजवळ 150 कार्यकर्ते केवळ आणि केवळ हे घेऊन आजही कोणीही पॉझिटिव्ह झालेलं नाहीये आणि त्यांचे घरच्यांना आणि अजूनही काही टेस्ट ठिकाणी मी दिलेलं आहे. त्यामुळे मी खात्रीपूर्वक सांगते आणि माझा एवढा विश्वास असल्या मी ह्याच्यासाठी खास डॉक्टर गोलवलकरजींचे जे ह्याचे जनक आहेत, म्हणायला पाहिजे हरित क्रांतीचं कोणी जनक असतं तर हे नीलक्रांतीचे जनक आहेत. नीलक्रांती म्हणतात असं आणि त्यांचे राईट अँड जे स्ट्रॉंग सपोर्टर डॉक्टर काकडियाजी आणि दुसरे स्ट्रॉंग सपोर्टर आणि मी ज्यांच्याकडे जाऊन माझे काही शंका दूर केल्या ते डॉक्टर रमेश शहा बोरिवलीला, मोठं त्यांचं आय सर्जन आहेत, मोठं हॉस्पिटल आहे. त्या दोघांनीही हे मिशन म्हणून हातात घेतले आणि मी सुद्धा एक मिशन म्हणून हातात घेतले. माझा भाऊ आहे डॉक्टर सुनीत राऊत पालघरला आहे, त्यांची मिसेस डॉक्टर सुशीला राऊत गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट आहे, त्यांनी सुद्धा याचा गेले 5 महिने अनुभव घेतलाय. आणि हे केवळ कोरोना प्रतिबंधक म्हणून नाही, कोरोना प्रतिबंधक तर ते आहेच, परंतु शरीरातले कुठलेही सूज, मग ती दाताची हिरड्यांची असो कानाची ओटायटिस मीडिया, हे सुद्धा बऱ्याच पेशंटचं बरं झालंय. म्हणजे ते घेतात कोरोना प्रिव्हेंटिव्ह म्हणून, परंतु त्यांचे इतर गुड इफेक्ट्स हे त्यांना लागतात. अँटीफंगल म्हणून सुद्धा ते काम करतं. एका माझ्या कार्यकर्त्याचे पूर्ण शरीरावर फंगल इन्फेक्शन होतं, डॉट 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 असे शरीरावर होते, ते सुद्धा त्यांचे नष्ट झाले. त्यामुळे मी डॉक्टर काकडियाजींचं इकडे स्वागत करते, ते ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ डॉक्टर गोलवलकरजी बोलणार. डॉक्टर गोलवलकरजी MD पल्मोनॉलॉजिस्ट आहेत आणि गेले 42 वर्ष भावनगरमध्ये आहेत, ते महाराष्ट्रातले पण भावनगरमध्ये जाऊन एक एक ऋणानुबंध असतात ना आपले. माझं लहानपण गुजरातमध्ये गेलं आणि मी मुंबईत स्थायी झाले. तसे डॉक्टर गोलवलकर हे गुजरातमध्ये भावनगरमध्ये प्रतिष्ठित डॉक्टर आहेत. 42 वर्ष ते लंग डिसऑर्डर ट्रीट करत आहेत आणि रोजचे 400 पेशंट OPD चे बघत आहेत. त्यामुळे त्यांची इंटरव्ह्यू आणि त्यांच्या वेबिनार मी अटेंड केल्या. मला एवढंच सांगायचं, आपण मिशन म्हणून हे हातात घेऊया. आज प्राण जात आहेत लोकांचे, पण धनाने सुद्धा धन सुद्धा जात आहे लोकांचं. पेशंट बरा होऊन तरी घरी आला तरी 9-9 लाखाचं बिल हातात असतं, तो एवढ्या शॉक मध्ये असतो की काय. आणि आजही मी तुम्हाला खात्रीपूर्वक सांगते, मी टास्क फोर्स मध्ये सदस्य आहे, अनेक डॉक्टरांशी बोलते आहे, आजही डॉक्टर सांगू शकत नाही की रेमडेसिवीर काम करते की टॉसिलिझुमाब काम करते की स्टिरॉइड काम करते, कशाने पेशंट बरा होतोय आणि एवढं देऊन सुद्धा पेशंट जातो, त्यामुळे तो कशाने गेला हेही ते सांगू शकत नाही. एवढा सगळं कन्फ्युजनचा विषय असताना जर एक डॉक्टर सांगत असेल की खात्रीपूर्वक, आणि त्यांनी WHO कडे प्रस्ताव पाठवले, डॉक्टर गोलवलकरने रिसर्च पेपर त्यांचे प्रस्तुत केलेत, परंतु ते मान्य करत नाही. ह्याच्या मागे काय कारण आहे हे आपण ओळखू शकतो. एवढी मोठी फार्मा लॉबी WHO वरती प्रेशराईज करते हेही आपल्याला कळते. त्यामुळे आपण तर सुजाण आहोत, आपण सुजाण वैद्य आहोत, त्यामुळे आपण ह्याच्यात लोकांच ओळखून घेऊया का आहे, कारण मोठी वॅक्सिन बनवणारी लॉबी कोणाच्या हातात आहे, WHO ते पण आपल्याला माहिती आहे, अमेरिकेचे कोण याच्यामध्ये आहे. त्यामुळे आपण अतिशय सावधगिरीने, जसे सीमेवर जवान लढत होते आणि अनेक स्वातंत्र्य सैनिक आपल्या घराच्या आजूबाजूला सगळं स्वतःचं योगदान देत होते, खारीचं वाटत घेऊन उचलत होते, तसंच हे आपलं मिशन आहे असं समजून आपण याच्यात काम करूया. आजच मी काल मी मुख्यमंत्र्यांची एक मीटिंग अटेंड केली, त्याच्यात टास्क फोर्स जे सगळे सदस्य आणि उपस्थित होते तेव्हा पण ते बोलले की मी त्यांना सजेस्ट केलं की एसओपीज आणि गाईडलाईन्स प्रोटोकॉल्स बनवा, कारण एसओपीज बनवली जात नाहीये. रेमडेसिवीर कधी वापरायची, टॉसिलिझुमाब कधी वापरायची, स्टिरॉइड्स कधी वापरायचे, आयसीयू बेड मिळत नाही म्हणून धावतात धावतात आणि आयसीयू बेड मिळाल्यावर 10 दिवस झालेले असतात पेशंटला पॉझिटिव्ह होऊन, त्यावेळेला त्यांना रेमडेसिवीरसाठी पुन्हा धावायला लावतात. त्यांनाही माहिती आहे ह्या स्टेजमध्ये रेमडेसिवीर आफ्टर 9 डेज इट इज ऑफ नो यूज, हे ठरलेलं आहे, माहिती आहे, तरी सुद्धा रेमडेसिवीरसाठी धावायला लावतात टॉसिलिझुमाब. कारण डॉक्टर पण संभ्रमात आहेत की हा पेशंट नाही वाचला तर पेशंटच्या नातेवाईकच सांगतील आम्हाला रेमडेसिवीर लिहून पण नाही दिलं, आम्ही कुठूनही मिळवलं असतं, लाख लाख वा आम्ही खर्च करायला तयार होतो असंही सांगतात. त्यामुळे आता ह्या एसओपीज जाहीर होतील आणि कोणत्या स्टेजमध्ये वापरायचं हे सुद्धा फार महत्वाची गोष्ट आहे. तर मी म्हणते की ठीक आहे, गावागावात तर अजूनही वाईट स्थिती आहे, गावामध्ये तर आयसीयू काय ऑक्सिजन बेड पण नाही आहे, एक किंवा दोन ऑक्सिजन बेड असतात आणि पेशंट 15 वर असतात पॉझिटिव्ह आणि सिरियस झालेले, त्याला मुंबईत येतात आणि इतकी वाईट असते. आता थर्ड वेव येणार आहे आणि थर्ड वेवची तयारी सुरू आहे, म्हणतात की लहान मुलं म्हणजे 10 ते 20 वर्षाची मुलं ह्याच्यात अफेक्ट होणार आहे, त्यामुळे आपण खूप तयारीशी आपण पोस्ट कोविड केअर म्हणून सुद्धा हे वापरू शकतो मिथिलिन ब्लू. मी अनेक पोस्ट कोविडच्या पेशंटना मिथिलिन ब्लू दिलेला आहे आणि कोविड होऊ नये म्हणून ज्यांना दिलं आहे त्यांना तर खरंच इफेक्ट झालेला आहे, त्यामुळे मला असं वाटतं की आपण ही एक क्रांती म्हणून घेऊया. मी सगळ्यांचे आभार मानते आणि माझं इथे कारण आपले आरोग्यमंत्री जॉईन होणार आहेत शेवटी शेवटी, कारण आता ते एका मिटिंगमध्ये बसले, जशी मिटिंग त्यांची संपेल तसे ते आपल्या मिटिंगमध्ये जॉईन होतील. मी एवढंच सांगते की आपण हे मिथिलिन ब्लू कुठे मिळेल तर बरेचसे फोन नंबर मागच्या वेळेला आम्ही दिले होते, डॉक्टर रमेशभाई शाह आहेत ते सुद्धा मिळवून देण्यामध्ये मदत करतात, आपण ते घ्या. आणि लोकांना जसं माझा भाऊ आहे डॉक्टर सुनीत राऊत पालघरमध्ये, तो प्रत्येक पेशंटला एवढं म्हणजे 50 ml तरी देतो आणि सांगतो 8 दिवस तुम्ही हे मिथिलिन ब्लू च्या गुळण्या करून गिळा आणि पॉझिटिव्ह झाले असतील तर त्यांना अशा प्रकारे, किंवा जे हेल्थ वर्कर्स आहेत फ्रंट वॉरियर आहेत त्यांना अशा प्रकारे नेब्युलायझर मधून द्यायला सांगतात आणि खरंच खूप इफेक्ट चांगला झाले. माझी इथेच मी संपवते माझं बोलणं, आपण पुढचं सुरू करावं. धन्यवाद.
थँक्यू मॅडम. मी मगाशी बोलताना थोडस राहून गेलो आपल्या या कार्यक्रमाच्या शेवटी. आपले राज्याचे आरोग्यमंत्री राजेश भैया जी पोपे हजर राहणार आहेत, तसेच डॉक्टर राजीव ढेरे जे डीन आहेत जम्बो कोविड सेंटर बांद्रा कुर्ला कॉम्प्लेक्स मुंबईच्या 2500 bedded कोविड सेंटरचे ते डीन आहेत, ते सुद्धा आपले अनुभव इथे आपल्याला सांगणार आहेत. मी डॉक्टर शुभा राऊळ मॅडमना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी पुढील सूत्रे आपल्या हातात घ्यावी, त्यांचा परिचय आणि
हा बरं. मी डॉक्टर गोलवलकरांचा परिचय देते. ज्याप्रमाणे मी सांगितलं की त्यांनी ही नील क्रांती हातात घेतली आहे आणि या नील क्रांतीचे जनक म्हणूनच त्यांचा आपण आता उल्लेख करायला हवा. आणि त्यांना मी तर म्हणते की ह्या सगळ्या ह्याच्यातून नोबेल पारितोषिक मिळवण्यासाठी सुद्धा सगळ्या जगभरातले डॉक्टर प्रयत्न करणार आहेत असं मला कळलेलं आहे, कारण त्यांचे प्रयत्न इतके निस्वार्थ आहेत. आणि डॉक्टर काकडियाजी त्यांना नमस्कार. डॉक्टर गोलवलकरजी, आम्ही धन्य आहोत कारण आम्हाला तुम्ही जेव्हा जेव्हा पाहिजे तेव्हा आम्हाला मार्गदर्शन केलेलं आहे, त्यामुळे तुमचे आभार मानते. आणि अक्षरशः इथून आम्ही नमस्कार करतो आणि आपले आशीर्वाद घेतोय आणि आम्ही हे काम आपलं सुरू केलेलं आहे महाराष्ट्रभर. डॉक्टर काकडियाजी आहेत ते पण खूप मोठे नामांकित आय सर्जन आहे, गुजरातमध्ये त्यांचं खूप मोठं नाव आहे. त्यांनी सुद्धा हे एक मिशन म्हणून हातात घेतलेलं आहे आणि डॉक्टर गोलवलकरच्या तर्फे ते बोलतात आणि त्यांनी अतिशय चांगल्या रीतीने समजावून दिलेलं आहे. डॉक्टर रमेशभाई शाह इकडे उपस्थित आहेत, त्यांनी सुद्धा मुंबईमध्ये हे मिशन म्हणून हातात घेतलंय आणि त्यांचे आम्ही सहकारी अशा रीतीने आम्ही सुद्धा हे मिशन हातात घेतलेलं आहे. डॉक्टर इथे डेरे उपस्थित असतील तर त्यांनाही मी नमस्कार करते, कारण त्यांनी आम्ही ठरवल्याप्रमाणे त्यांनी BKC कोविड सेंटरमध्ये, डॉक्टर गोलवलकरजी ऐका, BKC कोविड सेंटरमध्ये 300 ICU मधल्या पेशंटना IV मिथेलिन ब्लू सुरू केलेलं आहे आणि ही मोठी गोष्ट आहे, कारण ही एक म्हणजे आणि ते म्हणालेले आहेत की मला इतका चमत्कारिक ह्याच्यामध्ये रिझल्ट दिसत आहे. म्हणजे ह्याचा अर्थ प्रत्येकाने हे लक्षात घ्यावं, आय व्ही सुद्धा मिथेलिन ब्लू आपण सुरू करू शकतो, पेशंटची फक्त कन्सेंट घ्यावी लागते.
शुभा मॅडम
कन्व्हिन्स झाला.
शुभा मॅडम एक थोडस डिस्टर्ब करतो, बऱ्याच ठिकाणी बऱ्याच जणांच्या रिक्वेस्ट आहेत की हिंदी किंवा इंग्लिश मध्ये बोलावं, आपलं बोलणंही महत्वाचं आहे त्याच्यामुळे आपण.
डॉक्टर डेरे जी यहाँ पर उपस्थित है और उन्होंने बीकेसी कोविड सेंटर में एक रिसर्च के तौर पर ये अपना मिथेलिन ब्लू आईवी देना शुरू किया है और उनको इतने मैजिकल रिजल्ट मिल रहे हैं. तो मैं यही कहूंगी कि अगर प्राइवेट डॉक्टर्स है यहाँ पर हॉस्पिटल के, तो सिर्फ पेशेंट की कंसेंट लेके आप उसमें आपके हॉस्पिटल में आईवी दे सकते हैं मिथेलिन ब्लू. इतना ही मेरा मैसेज है. और बाकी तो नेबुलाइजेशन है, ओरल सबलिंगुअल है, ये दो तो आप एज अ प्रोफिलेक्टिक और ट्रीटमेंट के हिसाब से दे सकते हैं. लेकिन अगर आईसीयू में पेशेंट है तो भी एट एनी स्टेज यू कैन यूज आईवी मिथेलिन ब्लू इन नॉर्मल सलाइन. आपको उसका सभी सभी बातें आपको काकड़िया जी बताएंगे. मला वाटते एवढे बस झाले, म्हणजे माझं पूर्ण झालंय असं समजते.
थँक्यू मॅडम, चालेल. आपण सॉरी हिंदी मे थोडा सा बात करना है तो मैं कार्यक्रम आगे लेते जाते हुए डॉक्टर जगदीप यम काकड़िया सर से रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ कि वो अपना लेक्चर शुरू करें.
थैंक यू वेरी मच डॉक्टर शुभा जी, डॉक्टर संजय. आई बिगिन माय टॉक विद द ब्लेसिंग्स फ्रॉम डॉक्टर गोलवालकर on whose behalf actually I am speaking everywhere about Mithilin Blue, because he is the pioneer of reinventing the use of Mithilin Blue against the COVID. And sorry, are my slides visible?
Yes sir, visible.
Okay. So in the crusade against COVID, crusade against corona, we already have many weapons, and I'm speaking on behalf of Dr. Golwalkar from Bhavnagar, Dr. Ramesh Shah, Dr. Satish Sheth from Hubli, Karnataka. At the outset, I would like to specially thank Nima in general, as well as Dr. Shubha Rahul and Dr. Sanjay Londe in particular, for inviting me and Dr. Golwalkar and Dr. Ramesh Shah to speak and share our experience and what we have found and what are our views about the use of Mithilin Blue in COVID. This virus is so simple to be killed that even a simple soap water can kill it in 20 seconds. So in our mind, we feel, quite often we feel pain when people are suffering so much against such a tiny organism which can be so easily killed. And quite often we laugh when the people are so much confused, including the medical community. It's so simple and so easy. It's such a tiny particle to oxidize this virus lipid layer or to emulsify the virus's lipid layer and destroy its genome is such an easy task that we already have 100 to 125 years old weapons as powerful as Sudarshan Chakra or Brahmastra or Vajrastra or Indrastra. Only thing is that we don't know about it, or we haven't opened our mind about the weapons which we already have, like the UV lights, ANC, methylene blue, ozone, hydrogen peroxide, ivermectin, chlorhexidine, thymoquinone, coconut oil, povidone, iodine. And lastly, Dr. Golwalkar has also invented the use of 3% normal saline as a nebulization, about which he will talk during the panel discussion. So we already have 9 to 10 different weapons which can be used as a sword as well as a shield for fighting against this virus, but we don't know in detail about it. If we know it in the correct perspective, we can very quickly and very easily win this war against this virus and make the world free from corona. Dr. Deepak Golwalkar has already been introduced. He is my guru. as far as methylene blue and COVID is concerned. Dr. Ramesh Shah has also been introduced, and this is me, an eye surgeon from Bhavnagar. And I also acknowledge the inputs which we have received from Dr. Anil Patel from Surat, who is the pioneer of using methylene blue in India. He has used in more than 200 ICU patients. Dr. Rakesh Karathia, who is an MD from Surat, is a COVID specialist, who has treated more than 1,000 patients of COVID on OPD basis, just using methylene blue and nothing else. Dr. Vishnu Patel from Mahesana, the same. Dr. Madhukanta and Ramesh Desai from King Town, Surat, who has treated more than 4,500 patients just with methylene blue and nothing else on OPD basis. Dr. CJ Shukla from he's an MD from USA, who has treated more than 30 or 35 of his relatives in USA. Dr. Praful Vaidhi from Bahrain, who is the personal physician of the Sheikh of Bahrain, who has used methylene blue in Bahrain in so many of his patients. Dr. Satish Sheth from Hubli, who is associate professor at Karnataka Institute of Medical Sciences in Hubli, and about 80 other MDs from all over the nation and the world who have been sending feedback to me and Dr. Kodwalkar. So today we'll focus on methylene blue in the crusade against corona. Methylene blue is a wonder drug with a use of 144 years, but many qualified doctors are not aware of this drug and its potential. Many of them are not even ready to believe that methylene blue is a drug. And most people believe that methylene blue is a dye to stain cells in laboratories or to color jeans, denim, and cotton fabric. But there's no answer or there's no way to wake if somebody wants to remain ignorant. Or as Martin Luther King has said, apne agnyan ko gnyan samajh lena aur gnyan ko prapt karne se inkar kar dena. Isse badi aur koi swechhik murkhta nahi hai. There's nothing in the world is more dangerous than sincere ignorance and conscientious stupidity. So if you look at methylene blue's Wikipedia page, you will find that methylene blue, also known as methyl thionium chloride, is a salt. So understand that methylene blue is a salt. It's an end chemical. So the salt is a structure in the chemistry which is extremely stable for a very, very long period of time. And it needs least metabolism in liver, and it needs almost no active metabolism in kidney. So it's a salt which is used as a medication and dye. That means methylene blue is first a medication and secondarily a dye. Now, as a medication, it is mainly used to treat methemoglobinemia. Now, this methemoglobinemia is the condition which occurs in cyanide poisoning, nitrite poisoning, and carbon monoxide poisoning, and iphosphamide poisoning. But we now know that methemoglobinemia is the condition which occurs in the COVID disease also, because the coronavirus is very hungry for oxyhemoglobin and it converts oxyhemoglobin into methemoglobin. So if a drug is mainly meant for treatment of methemoglobinemia, it's very logical that it should be employed for the use in COVID disease also. It is typically given by injection into a vein. Now, people were not ready to believe that methylene blue is a drug, but it is an intravenous drug. And it is on the World Health Organization's list of essential and safe medicines. We'll discuss about that later. Now, there are so many publications, more than 5,200 publications, references you will find on Wikipedia and on Google, where it is categorically said that methylene blue used in presence of light can be an excellent treatment as a reliable SARS-CoV-2 plasma virus inactivator for the safety of blood and convalescent plasma. A recent paper published by Dr. Valeria Kaino and her team from University of Geneva, published on 14th August 2020, is categorically specific that methylene blue has a potent antiviral activity against SARS-CoV-2 even in the absence of UV activation in vitro. Methylene blue, this paper has come up from Dr. Damir Mozavik and his team from University of Miami, Florida. And the paper establishes that methylene blue inhibits the SARS-CoV-2 spike protein attachment to ACE2 receptor. The protein-protein interaction is blocked by methylene blue. That means the virus is not allowed to be latched, because virus latches on the mucosal cells because it has the key in the form of the spike protein to open the ACE2 receptor and enter. So endocytosis of the virus will be prevented by methylene blue is established by this paper. And this is US National Library of Medicine, the clinicaltrials.gov is the suffix of the government of United States. And even in United States, there are clinical trials which are going on for methylene blue as treatment of COVID-19. And you can please notice here that it's a phase 2 study. That means they have found very good results in phase 0 and phase 1 study. That's why they've allowed phase 2 study in a period of last just about 6 to 8 months. In this study, in the treatment group, they are using methylene blue 100 milligram capsules twice a day. That means they are giving 200 milligrams of methylene blue twice a day for 5 consecutive days. And if you Google methylene blue, there are more than 5,000 research papers, 18 lakh references. In 144 years of use and research, 128 years of publications, 1 crore and 1 lakh plus reference in the first published paper in the Lancet about methylene blue was as early as September 30, 1893, as a therapy for treatment of malaria with methylene blue. Methylene blue is available as injection. There are 4 companies in India who make methylene blue injections. It is also available as injections in Europe and in America. It is also available as an oral drug for food, for use as food, for use as drug, or for use as medicinal use. It is made in USA and is available online in USA. You can order from Amazon USA. It is also available as Uribell capsule containing methylene blue 10 milligrams in each capsule. It is also available as tablet where methylene blue content is 10.8 milligram. It is available as a cream because methylene blue is an excellent rejuvenator of the skin, and application of methylene blue can convert your skin about 10 to 15 years younger. And it's available as a derma application. It is also available as a mist. And it is also available as eye drops in several countries, and it's available online, so it has to be safe, otherwise the US government will not allow online eye drops availability on Amazon. It's available in Egypt also, and it's mentioned in the WHO model list of essential and safe medicines. On the entry 4.2.4, methylthioninium chloride, methylene blue as injection, 10 milligram per ml in 10 ml ampule. So every United Nations and WHO member nation is supposed to keep methylene blue because it's an antidote of cyanide and nitrate poisoning. It is supposed to be kept available at every nation, at every factory where these chemicals are used in the process of production. And we know that drug repurposing is well known from the effect of aspirin, minoxidil, metformin. All these drugs have been completely repurposed. So so there's no reason why we cannot think of repurposing methylene blue. And it is the privilege of the treating physician to use a drug as an off-label use. With the patient's consent, we have all the rights to do that. So Krishna Bhagavan has given us a promise that Sambhavami Yuge Yuge Mein Har Yug Mein Pragat Honga. Mujhe lag raha hai ki Methylene Blue ke swarup mein us Sudarshan Chakra leke ye pragat hue hain. Aur apna jo rashtra chinh hai usmein bhi 24 ghanton Ashok Chakra jo desh ki raksha karta hai. Aur Ashok Chakra bhi aaj dekhenge to ye Methylene Blue se hi chhapa jata hai hamare rashtra dhwaj mein. Aur agar aap sochenge, कभी आपने सोचा है कि जितने भी हमारे सेवियर गॉड्स हैं, ये सब के सब ब्लू हैं? आप महादेव ले लीजिए, विष्णु ले लीजिए, हनुमान जी ले लीजिए, या रामचंद्र जी, या श्री कृष्ण भगवान, या महाकाली, ऑल हैव बीन पेंटेड ब्लू. सो लेट अस टेक सम क्लू फ्रॉम दैट एंड लेट्स गो टू एक्सप्लोर द हिस्ट्री ऑफ मिथिलेन ब्लू, बिकॉज विदाउट नोइंग द हिस्ट्री वी कैन नाइदर नो और नॉर क्रिएट द फ्यूचर. So for future, understanding future, it is always best to understand the history. So let us move our gaze towards the history of methylene blue. Methylene blue was originally a plant, jasmandi jo hai wo Hindustan mein ugti hai, hina, उसी तरह से मिथिलेन ब्लू जो है इंडिगोफेरा टिंक्टोरा नाम का एक प्लांट हिंदुस्तान में नॉर्थ इंडिया में ग्रो होता था और व्हेन द ब्रिटिश केम दे फाउंड द यूटिलिटी ऑफ दिस डाई फॉर फैब्रिक कलरिंग एंड द फार्मर्स वर फोर्स्ड टू प्लांट मिथिलेन ब्लू इन प्लेस ऑफ द कैश क्रॉप्स एंड द लैंड स्टार्टेड गेटिंग डिग्रेडेड बाय दिस प्लांट तो उसकी वजह से बहुत गर्मी फैली चंपारण और बिहार और बंगाल के बहुत सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट में और इन 1859 एक नील विद्रोह हुआ एक नील क्रांति हुई और सॉरी नील क्रांति नहीं बट नील विद्रोह हुआ और ये नील विद्रोह की वजह से जो यहाँ से इंडिगो जा रही थी यूरोप में द वेजिटेबल डाई वो बहुत महंगी हुई और उसकी वजह से यूरोप में सिंथेटिक इंडिगो बनाने की एक मुहिम चालू हुई और उसमें सबसे पहले हेनरी कैरो नामक एक केमिस्ट्री के साइंटिस्ट थे इन्होंने 1876 की साल में 1876 में सबसे पहली बार सिंथेटिक इंडिगो बनाई और इस तरह मिथिलीन ब्लू जो है वो दुनिया की सबसे पहली सिंथेटिक केमिकल बनी फुल्ली मैन मेड केमिकल और दूसरा ये सबसे पहली फुल्ली मैन मेड ड्रग भी बनी और 1876 में जैसे ही इसका आविष्कार हुआ डॉक्टर पॉल एहरलिच फ्रॉम जर्मनी स्टार्टेड यूजिंग मिथिलीन ब्लू फॉर वेरियस पर्पसेस एंड व्हाइल स्टेनिंग मलेरियल पैरासाइट्स ही फाउंड दैट मलेरियल पैरासाइट्स डाई वेरी क्विकली सो ही स्टार्टेड यूजिंग मिथिलीन ब्लू फॉर इंट्रामस्कुलर इंट्रावीनस यूज टू ट्रीट मलेरिया एंड ही वाज द फर्स्ट टू फाइंड क्योर ऑफ सिफिलिस फर्स्ट टू मेक द ट्रीटमेंट फॉर एंटी डिप्थीरिया एंड मेक द एंटी डिप्थीरिया सीरम He was first to demonstrate how to stain fungi, bacteria, and protozoa with methylene blue. He coined the names antimicrobial chemotherapy and the magic bullet. He saved millions of lives for which he was awarded Nobel Prize in 1908. And this is Dr. Albert Mosetic, who was professor and head of general surgery. He is the inventor of the first aid kit. He is inventor of the tincture of iodine for war wound disinfection and he is the prime pioneer of intramuscular injection of mycelium blue and in 1877 to 1993 he treated more than 300 patients of osteosarcoma of femur by injecting mycelium blue into the lesion. Dr. John Henry Clark, who is an eminent physician from Britain, he was MD in medicine as well as MD in homeopathy. So he had both the qualifications and he is the person who wrote Materia Medica, the main book of the homeopathy, in which on fourth chapter is entirely dedicated to Mycelium Blue. He has already authored 24 homeopathic books and Mycelium Blue has been described in one full chapter in Materia Medica. In homeopathy. So it's a homeopathic drug also. Dr. Deepak Golwalkar has already been introduced. We are happy that he is here with us and I am very lucky to have observed him working in his clinic quite often and to have been getting inputs and learning so many things from him. And Dr. Anil Patel, as I said, from Surat, the pioneer of intravenous use of mycelium blue. And I would like to hear recall for all of you that when we were young, when we used to develop sty ya to koi boil ho raha tha, to hum school mein fountain pen ki shahi wahan laga dete the aur wo mit jata tha. Because the fountain pen ink was containing mycelium blue and it used to kill the bacteria and kill the infection. We used to use mycelium blue for the wounds you would get in the playground. To prevent the infection. So mycelium blue is not a new drug. We just need to revisit it. And the aquaria, the professional and the home and domestic aquaria all over the world, they use mycelium blue to prevent viral, fungal and bacterial infection between the different species of the fish which are in the same environment, in the same confinement. And it is Dr. Golwalkar who found the reinvention of the drug from observing the mycelium blue being used to treat aquarium fishes about which he will hear from his own mouth. Now let us go and explore what are the mechanism actions of mycelium blue and why mycelium blue is so relevant in the treatment of COVID disease. But before that, let us understand there are two types of COVID. One is the COVID coryza, the upper respiratory tract in COVID, as long as it is above the voice box, above the larynx, in the nasal passages, in the oral passages, it is balle balle corona, because here the chances of patient's recovery are very good and the complications will be minimal. The other form of corona is below the larynx. Once the virus enters the trachea and enters into the bronchus and infects the lung, it becomes a pneumonia. और ये जो कोरोना है वो बुरी वाले कोरोना है, ये बहुत बहुत डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन है. सो हर हाल में हमने वायरस को वॉइस बॉक्स को क्रॉस करने से पहले खत्म कर देना है, या तो एंट्री नहीं देना है, अगर एंटर हो गए तो खत्म कर देना है. एंड वी विल सी हाउ मिथिलीन ब्लू इज एक्सट्रीमली यूजफुल एंड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ड्रग फॉर प्रिवेंशन ऑफ न्यूमोनिया इन द अर्ली फेज और कंप्लीट प्रोफाइलेक्सिस ऑफ कोविड. As I said, there are so many publications which have come up. This is the publication which has come up from the Institute of Transfusion Medicine, Academy of Military Medical Sciences from Beijing. The inactivation of SARS coronavirus in human plasma by methylene blue. And this paper was published as early as 2005, 1st January. This was about SARS-CoV-1 virus. And it established that 5 micromole per liter methylene blue inactivates 6.5 log. Now 6.5 log means 99.999995% of the viruses were destroyed in 3 minutes by the use of methylene blue. And the same findings were also observed by the same team, which was published on 17 March in 2020. So the first paper was about SARS-CoV-1 virus. This paper is about SARS-CoV-2 virus. And they found the same dosage. And I have been visiting lecturer to this and other some of the other universities in China. And I have been frequently visiting China and giving lectures in China through an interpreter, because nobody understands English over there. And this is Dr. David Peng Lu, the head of the Department of Ophthalmology, who is my friend and my translator. I also teach and educate the residents for glaucoma and cataract surgeries over there. We hold cataract surgery camps in rural China and help their medical system. So I have seen them and their work and how they use methylene blue with the photodynamic therapy. Now, let us come to the action. Methylene blue has multiple mechanisms of action, 7 or 8 actions against this virus. First thing is, it is virucidal. It kills corona and almost all other RNA viruses, bacteria and fungi, up to the size of malarial protozoa in few minutes. And it kills by oxidation, reduction, and by electron bombarding. By bombarding nascent oxygen and hydroxyl ion. So the drug resistance to methylene blue is extremely unlikely, because it is an electron gun. You just imagine that it is a machine gun, which is firing number of electrons on the microbes and destroying it. So there is no way the microbes can develop resistance against this drug. So it is virucidal, number one. Now this is the reason why I would I suggest that you stop methylene blue if vaccine dose is to be taken. This is the message which I wanted to give very clearly, because we have to stop methylene blue one day before, because that is the washout time. And don't start methylene blue again for 6 days after taking the shot, because otherwise the methylene blue will bombard and oxidize the vaccine viruses also, and the vaccine will be neutralized almost as good as distilled water. So 1 day before and 5-6 days after the vaccine dose, stop methylene blue. Second action of methylene blue is viral static. It is an antiviral because it makes cellular cytoplasm and extracellular fluid into an alkaline medium with pH 7.6 or above. And novel coronavirus does not replicate in alkaline medium. It needs an acidic medium. So methylene blue is a viral growth inhibitor, and chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine both are step derivatives of methylene blue, and they share and work by this same alkalinizing property. Elemental zinc also works on the same principle, and antacid being given to the patients of COVID again has the same mechanism of action to reduce the acidity of the blood and increasing the alkalinity. Now, the third action of methylene blue is anti-endocytosis. That means it is anti-entry. It prevents the entry of virus, as I said, by denaturing the spike protein and blocking the ACE2 inhibitor. And this paper is worth reading from University of Miami, Florida. This is the chemical structure of methylene blue. As you can see here, it's a nitrosulfate benzene ring. Methylene blue has two nitrosulfate benzene ring, whereas chloroquine has one nitrosulfate benzene ring. Quinine has one and a half, and hydroxychloroquine has one. So chloroquine, quinine, and hydroxychloroquine all are the step derivatives. The methylene blue is grandmother, quinine is the daughter, and chloroquine is granddaughter, and hydroxychloroquine is the great granddaughter of methylene blue. Now, methylene blue also has a very interesting mechanism. As I said earlier, it reverses the methemoglobinemia. It is the and only chemical treatment of methemoglobinemia, and if given in intravenous in a dose of 1 milligram to 2 milligram per kilo body weight, methylene blue can reverse methemoglobinemia in about 40 minutes. Now, coronaviruses are hungry for ferrous ions, so once they are in the blood, they convert ferrous ions to ferric ions in normal hemoglobin, and this leads to a condition from oxyhemoglobin to methemoglobin. And there is a slow building up of this methemoglobinemia, which is giving rise to happy hypoxia. If somebody closes your nose and mouth, within 2 minutes you will develop hypoxia. But if there is sudden hypoxia, your brain notices it, and you will start trying to relieve and get the oxygen. But when this methemoglobin formation is gradual over a period of 8 to 9 days, your neurons do not notice it, and that's the reason why the patient doesn't feel the feeling of hypoxia even if the oxygen level goes to 70. And this happy hypoxia is one of the reasons why many patients are late to go to the hospital. And methemoglobinemia is reversed by methylene blue. This is oxyhemoglobin, this methemoglobin. And if you give to a methemoglobinemic patient intravenous methylene blue, the patient will start from blue to pink within 40 minutes. Methylene blue also has an anti-inflammatory action. It is anti-cytokine. Upon chemical contact, it inactivates NLRP3 inflammasome, the entire complex, interleukin-6, TNF-alpha. It stops the secretion of IL-1 beta and IL-18. So these are the five chemicals which are produced by the patient's dying white blood cells, which have been overwhelmed and taken over by millions of coronaviruses. So once the phagocytosis of the virus is done by the lymphocytes, they explode, they die, and they release the cytoplasm. And that cytoplasm is containing all these chemicals, which leads to the cytokine storm. And this is the reason why you observe after 5 or 6 days, there is a lymphocytopenia, because all the lymphocytes have engulfed the viruses and they are dying and they're releasing the cytokine chemicals. And methylene blue has been very well documented to prevent this cytokine storm because it inactivates all these chemicals upon contact. And there are enough number of scientific reports in the public domain, not now, published before 2017, that methylene blue inhibits NLRP3 and NLRC4, AIM2, and non-canonical inflammasome activation. So methylene blue has already been proven as anti-inflammatory and anti-cytokines way before even the COVID-19 disease came. Okay, now methylene blue also has another interesting property, which is anticoagulant, because it helps to prevent intravascular coagulation by reducing thrombin, fibrinogen, and factor 8 level. It actually inhibits the thrombin and fibrinogen production. So lungs, alveolar, capillary blockage is cleared, which helps in clearing the pneumonia rapidly and prevents post-COVID coagulopathies, which we know that many patients who come out of the COVID ICU and after a week or 10 days, all of a sudden, they die because of the heart attack or because of the cardiorespiratory arrest, because they develop such large clot in the ventricle or atrium or in the vascular tree of the pulmonary vessels. So also methylene blue prevents the septicemic shock. It prevents peripheral vasodilation and hypotonic shock. In viral sepsis, three chemicals named bradykinin, nitric oxide, and cyclic guanosine monophosphate are secreted towards the end of the disease. And these hormones cause peripheral blood vessels to dilate, which causes the blood pressure to fall below a critical limit. As a result, kidneys and liver receive very little blood for perfusion, which leads the heart to slow down, and it becomes a vicious cycle and ultimately leading to multi-organ failure and an almost certain death. Now, this condition is known as hypoperfusion septicemic shock, and Methylene Blue, if given intravenous, inactivates as well as stops the production of nitric oxide and cyclic GMP, and thus it prevents and reverses the deadly hypovolemic shock. So if used well in time, rupees 200 into 5 injection of Methylene Blue at a cost of rupees 1000 are, in our opinion, equal to injection Remdesivir 10 doses, 50,000 rupees, injection Tocilizumab 1 dose, 40,000, tablet Favipiravir, anticoagulants, other therapy. So a 1000 rupees Methylene Blue therapy can probably balance the same number of actions which we would spend 110,000 rupees on other drugs, multiple combination. This one drug is all the things which we want to prevent or to treat the COVID disease. Now, this is very interesting action which has been found by Dr. Deepak Golwalkar. It has a strong anti-fibrosis action. It prevents and reverses to a great extent post-COVID lung fibrosis. Many persons who have recovered from COVID pneumonia have now been found to develop slow or fast lung fibrosis. Interstitial lung fibrosis, if significant, leads to restricted lifestyle because they become dependent on oxygen, and they cannot even climb 10 flights of a stair. They may need permanent oxygen support. Such patients are highly prone to other secondary lung infections. US green card or Canada, Australia, and New Zealand PR is denied if the embassy finds in their X-ray during the medical examination that the patient has lung fibrosis. They think that this is due to the tuberculosis, and the visa is flatly refused. But 0.1% Methylene Blue aqueous solution taken daily as 5 ml as nebulization for about 3 months after recovery from COVID pneumonia reverses the fibrosis, and we'll see the evidences which have been gathered by Dr. Golwalkar, on whose behalf I'm going to present this. This is the digital subtracted X-ray of the COVID disease, where you find that all these silvery linings are because of the hyaline deposition, which is the typical feature of COVID disease, and very strong consolidation of the lung. And all these areas, whatever areas have been consolidated in the pneumonia after the patient, if at all survives, when he recovers, all these areas will become eventually fibrosed and dysfunctional lungs. So whatever normal lung, only will remain the functional lungs. Suppose if a patient has a CT score of 50 and he survives and he recovers, imagine that half of his lung is already gone as far as the oxygen absorption and transfer capacity is gone. Now, this is the main normal bronchus, and this is the bronchoscopic picture. This is the deposition which is caused by the COVID virus. It is a hyaline deposition. It's a silvery, plasticky kind of a membrane. In case of a normal influenza, the secretion is very loose and frothy. जिसको हम बलगम के स्वरूप में बलगम पक जाता है, फिर खांसी खा खा के निकाल देते हैं पेशेंट. But this secretion does not come out because they are scaly, and we'll see this in video. This is the video of a normal influenza where you can see the frothy mucus, and this mucus with mucolytic agents will dissolve and melt, and the patient will be able to expectorate it out as bulgum, as an expectoration. But if you see the bronchoscopic video, which has been by courtesy of Dr. Golwalkar, in the next slide, you will realize how bad is the secretion induced by the COVID virus. This is the secretion, which is a sticky membrane. It is as if like the Favicol has been poured into your lungs, and the Favicol has dried up and made the scale. It's a silvery hyaline membrane, and there's no way but to go into the bronchus. You have to peel this out by bronchoscopic forceps. No medication will destroy this. Only Methylene Blue will dissolve this. If taken, Methylene Blue is taken as a nebulization. So this is the patient of moderately severe pneumonia, Dr. Golwalkar's X-ray, Dr. Golwalkar's patient's X-ray. And this much lung fibrosis can be reversed by Methylene Blue in about a month and a half of nebulization. This is another patient. The left lung is almost gone. and right lung is partially gone, and you can see that with methylene blue, the lung is almost back to the normal function and the fibrosis is reversed. And this is another patient of Dr. Gulwalkar with extensive fibrocavitation of lung induced by miliary tuberculosis. And this patient was almost about to die, and over a period of about a year or a year and a half of methylene blue inhalation, Dr. Gulwalkar has reversed this patient's fibrosis. So there is concrete evidence that the
methylene blue... your voice, Dr. Kakadia ji?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Hello.
Yes, now we can hear.
Okay. Okay. So this is the extensive fibrocavitation lesion, fibrosis and cavitation of the lung after severe miliary tuberculosis. And this patient's fibrosis, this patient was about to die. And Dr. Gulwalkar started him on methylene blue as nebulization, and in about 12 to 14 months time, his fibrosis completely reversed. So methylene blue, and this is the X-ray of Dr. Gulwalkar's own mother. She stopped taking methylene blue after getting vaccination, and she contracted COVID. She was 92 and a diabetic since 20 years. And this was the extensive lung involvement of hers. And on 27th of March, as recent about a month ago, and after the treatment of his own, her own son, the great own son, she had all her pneumonia cleared in 5 or 6 days' time. Unfortunately, she succumbed after another week or so to a massive heart attack. But she came out of severe COVID disease, pneumonic stage, in 6 days' time at the age of 92, having 20 years of diabetes. So Dr. Gulwalkar's advice is to use 5 ml of 0.1% methylene blue, use 1 ml of dexamethasone, because dexamethasone is essential to prevent inflammation, and duoline or Combimist L to dilate the bronchioles so that methylene blue can easily penetrate right up to the alveoli. He will comment more during the question answer session. And this is another complication which now we are seeing right and left. The mucormycosis, because this is the lodgement of the fungus in the retroorbital space, paranasal sinuses, and the patient comes out of ICU, comes home, and after about 20 days becomes toxic again, and they develop severe mucormycosis. And you can imagine that the oxygen mask on this child has lost so much of mucormycete spores. Now, what is mucormycete? Mucormycete indicus is a common fungus. The spores are everywhere in the environment, in the domestic environment also. If the bread rots, we get this black fungus. We get this fungus growth on the rotting wood, on palm, on rotting fruits. Everywhere it's there. Now, the methylene blue has a strong antifungal property. And this fungus does not respond to normal, the azole dyes. It does not respond to the fluconazole derivatives. It does not sometimes respond even to amphotericin B. But it does respond well to methylene blue because it is very hungry for energy, and methylene blue is an energy giver drug. So it takes up methylene blue very quickly. And as soon as methylene blue enters the fungal cell, it destroys the mitochondria by over-oxidation, and the fungus starts dying. Now, the reason for this fungus, we have found, I personally have been asking so many people, so many microbiologists, most of them are saying that this fungus gets into your nasal sinuses by the route of oxygen, because the oxygen passes through the humidifier, and the humidifier is containing the tap water, because none of the ICU sterilizes or autoclaves the humidifier bottle, and the water which is filled in the humidifier is taken straight from the tap water, and the tap water is containing the spores of algae. It also contains the spores of mucormycetes indicus, because the tap water supplied by municipality does not check for the fungal spore. They check only for E. coli, they check only for the Klebsiella and typhus, bacteria and colony count of the bacteria only. They don't check anything for the fungus. So this water is containing fungus. The non-sterile water and non-sterile bottle is used for humidifying the oxygen. So the patient is on a humidified oxygen for 15 to 20 days. Patient is on steroid, patient is on immunosuppressant, and all these fungal spores have lodged in their sinuses and the nose because the oxygen has brought those, and oxygen has provided the rich environment for this fungus to grow. Also, blood sugar, high blood sugar because of the glycolysis induced by the steroid and the immunosuppression induced by remdesivir or tocilizumab. So there is an extremely good environment for this fungus to lodge and grow in 15 to 20 days time. So the patient has recovered from COVID and now is going to succumb to mucormycosis because we do not have an effective drug to treat mucormycosis. And Dr. Gulwalkar has found a very intelligent suggestion that instead of using simple water, use methylene blue itself in the nebulizer so that the patient is receiving not only sterile water where methylene blue has destroyed all the fungal spore in the nebulizer and in the humidifier bottle itself, the patient is also receiving methylene blue continuously, which is helping to maintain the oxygen level by reversing the methemoglobinemia. So thank you, Dr. Gulwalkar, for this intelligent innovation for sharing with us. And with his guidance, we have gained some experience of using intravenous methylene blue also, about which I think he will talk better for us. Again, I pay my respect and my in-depth I declare my indebtedness to whatever knowledge I have gained going in ICU with him and treating patients with him. So an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. So methylene blue is really an extraordinary drug for prophylaxis and treatment of the early disease of COVID. And let us visit the slides about how to use methylene blue for the prevention of disease, because it has all the actions which we want. Now, this is not a prescription nor an advocacy about methylene blue. We are just sharing what we have found. And you have to take your decision, exploring the knowledge and the information which we share and which Google and Wikipedia share on your own best judgment. We have no financial interest in any of the product which will be described. Dr. Gulwalkar's slogan is Buri Dawa Gar Lo Nirantar To Corona Rakhega Aap Se Antar. That means it is extremely useful for prophylaxis. And his another sutra is Buri Dawa Muh Ke Andar To Corona Ho Jai Chumantar. That is the treatment of the early phase of the COVID disease. So according to him and according to all the literature, methylene blue is a sword as well as shield. Ye dal bhi hai, ye talwar bhi hai. As I said, there are enough number of references and published papers all over the world, which gives us very good idea that it kills the virus. Not only it kills, but in what dose it kills the papers. So if we calculate the dose based on molar concentration, which is very complicated, so I'll skip that, but the virus dose calculation done based on the latest paper published by Geneva Institute, Dr. Valeria Kaino, the dose needed to kill the virus 99.95% is 0.08 microgram per 1 milliliter. Now, an average human body of 70 kilogram weight has 50 liters of water. So 50,000 ml is the water content of a person who is 70 kg. Multiplied it by 0.08 microgram, so that comes to 4,000 microgram. Now 4,000 microgram is 4 milligram. So if a person of 70 kilogram gets 4 milligram methylene blue every day, it gets diluted and spreads in 50 liter of the body water, and that is enough to kill 99.95% of the viruses, even if the viruses are in blood. A little overdose is advisable because the methylene blue is never 100%. It's about 98 or 98.5% active drug in 1 gram of powder, for example. Also, the absorption is never 100%. So I personally now advocate to all my colleagues and my friends that do a little overdose. So take a 5 milligram or 5 ml of methylene blue instead of taking 4 milligram. And the upper dose, the toxic dose of methylene blue is 300 milligrams. So taking 5 milligram in place of 4 milligram is no hazard at all. And if you prepare a solution of 0.1%, that means 1 milligram powder dissolved in 1 ml water. So that gives us very good and ease of measurement that if you take 5 ml of 0.1%, that means you are taking 5 milligram of methylene blue into your body. So just remember the equation 1 milligram in 1 ml, which will be useful in the next slides. So for this double mutant, highly virulent strain, 4 milligram of 0.1% is needed. I suggest 5 ml instead of 4 ml. And toxicity dose is when given above 400 ml or 400 milligrams. So nothing to worry about that one extra ml. Now, weight-wise dose would be for a 70 kg person, say 5 ml. For 100 kg person, it should be 7.5 ml. For a 40 kilogram person, it should be 3 ml. For a 20 kilogram young boy, it should be 1.5 ml. So calculate the dose accordingly, 70 kilo, 5 ml. And then you can titrate by multiplying or by dividing. Now, how shall we prepare a 0.1% methylene blue for taking 5 ml? So my personal recommendation is that you take methylene blue injection, which is 1%, which is 100 ml, and add one injection to 90 milliliters of sterile pure RO water or good quality water. You don't need it to be sterile. It will become sterile once methylene blue goes in. It will kill all the organisms present there, but you need a good quality water. So 90 ml water and 10 ml of methylene blue injection, if they are mixed, it gives you 0.1 ml solution. What I do is I take two injections and add these two injections to a 200 ml bottle of Bisleri, removing a little bit from the top. So this gives me a 0.1 or approximate 0.1% solution, and this is what I personally use for myself. Methylene blue is available as injection, ample and in free quantity. You can contact Mr. Mehul Chaturvedi at this number if you want to buy methylene blue for Vulcan Laboratories. This is a Kolkata-based company owned by Gujarati. This is another company, the MD of which is Mr. Shailesh Bhai Patel. They are the largest manufacturer of methylene blue injection. Their office is in Navi Mumbai, their plant is in Baroda, and they produce thousands of methylene blue injection every day. This is another company. Mr. NL Tandon is the main person. Arshad Siddiqui is also the main person. This is Samarth Pharma. They also manufacture huge quantity of methylene blue injection. And there's another company in Maharashtra near Pune in a village known as Amboli, T. Walker and Company, from where also you can get methylene blue injection. Now, if you can't get it, the second option is to get methylene blue for microscopy stain. This is laboratory grade methylene blue, which contains a purity of 96% versus the purity of 98.5% in case of a pharma drug. So this is reasonably good option, and you can use this. You can find from your local microbiology, science college microbiology or biology department professor, from where they buy methylene blue powder for staining in their microbiology laboratory, because every laboratory will have methylene blue for the histopathological staining. And if you wish, or if anybody wants to buy a bulk methylene blue powder, Harshad Bhai Shah in Bombay is one of the largest manufacturer of the pharma grade and the laboratory grade methylene blue powder, as well as the powder. Now, here I would like to bring to your notice that methylene blue is also available as a dye for fabric coloring, which is having only about 70 to 80% of the active drug. And it does contain nickel and arsenic and heavy metals as an additional contaminants. And this is the powder which comes as a brown tapkir, or as a brown powder. When you add this to water, it becomes blue. But when it is dry as a powder, it is brown. And this is the powder which is not for human consumption. This is for the coloring of the fabric. So this powder has very low content of the active drug and very high content of the contaminant. So please avoid the use of industrial grade methylene blue as a dye. USP pharma grade methylene blue is green or greenish blue crystals rather than being the powder. And this is the best quality of methylene blue. So avoid using the brown powder. Use either blue or green powder for making the solution. I have got the industrial grade and dye grade methylene blue tested by several laboratories, and we found that it has very, very high nickel content, 855 milligram versus the maximum allowed dose of 0.1 milligram. And arsenic is 6 milligram versus 0.05 milligram, the allowed dose. So industrial dye is not to be used by any voluntary organization who wants to distribute methylene blue free of cost to their, you're trying to save the cost on good quality methylene blue. You are going to induce heavy metal poisoning over a period of next 5 to 6 months, and there'll be another epidemic of such a disease after the COVID is gone. So I'm strongly against using industrial grade brown color dye. Now, once you get the pharma grade or laboratory grade powder, let me show you how we can make the methylene blue at home. You take a jeweler's scale, which you can buy from any jewelry shop. They use it for weighing the gold or the diamond in carats. So you put a paper or any dish and then switch it on. So it will cancel the weight of the paper or the dish which you have put. Now take 1 gram of the pharma grade powder. And this 1 gram, this scale is available for around 200 to 300 rupees on Amazon. You can buy it from any jewelers. Now this 1 gram powder is to be added to 1 liter of water. Now 1 gram of powder is containing 1000 milligram and 1 liter of water is containing 1000 milliliter. So we have now got 1 milligram in 1 milliliter, and that is the sutra which I gave you in the first slide. So that makes us 0.1% methylene blue aqueous solution. So just remember 1 gram in 1 liter, or just remember 1 milligram in 1 milliliter. And this is how I prepare for my staff and for my family and my patients who come to me for methylene blue. We take a Kinley mineral water bottle, which is exactly 1000 ml. There are some local companies making mineral water, which does not have enough quantum of water, or the quality of the water is also not good. So I would suggest either use Bisleri or Kinley or some standard company who are good in standardization of their quantity as well as their quality of water. And now you can take 5 ml of methylene blue, keep it sublingual, hold it there, and after about a minute or so, you can gulp it. So after making methylene blue, there are so many questions which people ask me. So let me explain that it is pan-virucidal, it is pan-bactericidal and pan-fungicidal. So it does not need any preservative. It kills all microorganisms present in the water, will not allow any growth. So no need for any preservative, no need for buffer or pH compensating solution, because methylene blue has redox potential. It balances its own pH and it's a salt, so it doesn't need any buffering. It is a basic organic nitrobenzene-based azothiazine chemical, not really a pharma drug, so it has almost infinite shelf life. As I said, salt does not degrade over a period of time. So like sodium chloride will last as long as the earth would last, the same way methylene blue, being a salt, would last as long as the earth would last theoretically, but practically let us consider at least 5 years of shelf life after the reconstitution. There's no need for refrigerator storage, because at any temperature it is stable, because it is a salt. So salt is stable at any temperature and the boiling point is 150 degrees. So methylene blue will stay as is till the mother earth is as is. And for 5 ml quantification, most of the people, they speak ki ek chamach lena hai, do chamach lena hai. But chamach ki size jo hai, wo har ghar mein alag alag hai, aur ek ghar mein bhi alag alag size ke chamach hai. So we have to first find which spoon of your household is 5 ml. So what you can do is take a disposable syringe, take 5 ml of methylene blue and drop it into a chamach, and you will find which chamach is the right size of 5 ml. Usually the tablespoon is 5 ml. So you can also purchase a measuring spoon, which is available for chef for cooking and for recipes. So this has all the various measurements, and 5 ml or 5 gram is available. And I personally take methylene blue twice a day because I'm daily exposed to 60-70 patients of my own, that is eye patients. And there are many patients who do not get an appointment in Dr. Gulalkar's place because he is busy from 9 a.m. to 12:30 in the midnight. So some patients who don't get his appointment, they come to me. And quite often I see 8 to 10 patients of COVID. And if I feel I can treat, I continue. I discuss with Dr. Gulalkar on phone and then modify the treatment. If I feel I cannot, then I send to them. So my own exposure level is so much that I feel that I should take it twice a day. Because methylene blue gets washed from your body in about 14 to 16 hours. So if you want to keep around the clock protection, because of your exposure, you take it twice a day. But if your exposure level is not so high, then you can take it once a day. That should be enough. और पूरे दिन जो अगर आपकी जीभ जो है नीली रहती है तो समझ लीजिए आपने सुबह और शाम दो बार जामुन खाए हैं. Don't worry about the blue tongue, but that blue tongue will definitely protect you. समझ लीजिए कि कृष्ण भगवान को एक मिथिलिन ब्लू के स्वरूप में आपने मुंह में रख दिया है. विश्व स्वरूप दिखाया था, पूरा मुंह खोल के अपने मुंह में कृष्ण भगवान को सुदर्शन चक्र को ले लिया है ब्लू स्वरूप में. इफ यू फील इट इज वेरी बीटर इन द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन 0.1%, देन बिकॉज इट इज वेरी बीटर, इट इज द मदर ऑफ क्विनाइन, सो इट हैज टू बी बीटर. So if you feel it is very bitter, then you can add 5 ml of this to about 50 ml, half glass of water. इसमें आप थोड़ा नींबू भी डाल सकते हैं, और डायबिटिक नहीं है तो नींबू का स्वीट जूस भी बना सकते हैं, नींबू पानी में ले सकते हैं, as if you are drinking a sherbet. Do it very slowly, so there's enough time for methylene blue to get absorbed in the oropharyngeal mucosa as well as on the tongue. This is Dr. Madhukanta and Dr. Ramesh Desai from Kim Town in District Surat. I've given the mobile number. They are GPs and they have treated over 4,200 COVID patients. Dr. Ramesh Desai is a gynecologist. Dr. Madhukanta, his wife, is a GP. She has treated over 4,200 COVID patients just by using methylene blue, and all patients treated on OPD basis. She gives on day one 20 ml of methylene blue as a bolus. And then she gives second bolus in the evening, 15 ml, and on third morning, about 15 ml. So in three dose of large dose of methylene blue, and none of their patients have progressed to pneumonia, none of them needed admission. So you can contact them if you want to find their protocol, how they are using it. Dr. Rakesh Kalathia from Surat, he has treated over 600 patients using IV methylene blue on OPD basis. He owns a 20-bedded COVID ICU, but he says that since I started using methylene blue, my admission rate has decreased almost to 20% from 100%. And she's my wife, Dr. Ila. She found a very smart idea of impregnating a Sitobladi Ayurvedic tablet, which is hygroscopic. So she takes 0.5 ml of methylene blue injection undiluted. She impregnates the Sitobladi tablet. So this I can take whenever I travel so that I don't have to carry liquid methylene blue, because I'm always afraid that liquid methylene blue is not allowed to be carried in my handbag in the flights. And if I put it in my bag and if there is a leak, my all clothes would become blue, stained. So this is a very nice idea for those who have constant traveling, like MR, like the doctors who are constantly on the traveling. They can, instead of carrying liquid methylene blue, can carry tablets, homemade tablets of methylene blue. This is septylene. This is another experiment. Septylene also hygroscopic. It absorbs methylene blue. So you can use an insulin syringe, take 0.5 ml from the injection directly undiluted, and impregnate the tablet to be taken with you on your travels. This is one paper which has come up from UK where they are using nebulizer, and this is the therapy which actually was invented by Dr. Golwalkar as long as early as 2004 for the patients of tuberculosis as well as for the patients of swine flu. He must have saved more than 600 patients of swine flu, which had a very high mortality rate from 2009 to 2012. He treated so many patients of swine flu. And the nose knows it first is the English proverb. The entry point of the virus mostly is the nose. So now Dr. Golwalkar and on his footsteps, I also have started recommending all our patients that not only you take it per oral and sublingual, but you also put 2 drops of methyl blue in your nose once or twice in a day, so that if there is at all there is any entry of virus, and before they colonize, before they ledge, let them oxidize. So this is how we put methylene blue nasal drops. And Dr. Ramesh Shah has got a batch of 1,000 methylene blue nasal drops as well as eye drops from a pharma company in Bombay. So he can help you providing methylene blue nasal drops if anyone wants. If you want to make it yourself, just purchase the glass bottles with droppers like this, which are available at any perfume shop. Any Atharwala will be able to provide you, or you can buy it online and use it for the nasal dropping. Or you can buy a set like this, which will be 5 ml spoon, which will also be a 0.1 ml or half ml for putting the nasal drops. The dropper can be used. And the nebulization is the best, even better than the nasal drops as per Dr. Golwalkar, and it is very logical because nasal drops will cover only the nasal mucosa, but nebulizer will cover also the paranasal sinuses, because the nebulization of the methylene blue will enter and go into paranasal sinuses, as well as it will go right into the lungs up to the bronchioles and the alveoli. So if you want to cover your entire respiratory tract with methylene blue, use nebulizer. That will be the best way. And this is Dr. Golwalkar's clinic. And here you can see that one patient of COVID is being nebulization, being trained how to take nebulization at home. And here you can see Dr. Golwalkar. He treats about 80 to 90 COVID patients every day, and he has never worn PPE kit. And most of the times he doesn't wear the mask also. And I would like to tell you here that he does not wear the mask, not for the purpose that he wants to break the advisory or break the law. But he said to me that I'm making myself a guinea pig, that in spite of seeing 90 patients of COVID, active COVID every day, if I'm not wearing the mask and at my age of 70 for last 1 year, if I'm not getting positive, that itself is a proof enough that methylene blue is preventive. And not only him, I have seen all his staff of 10, his nearby medical store who is handling and supplying medications to all these 90-100 patients every day. The X-ray clinic and the CT clinic next to his door, who are doing 80-90 X-rays every day, and the laboratory, who are taking the blood and doing blood analysis of all these patients. So there are at least 100 staff working on his floor in his building. And none of them have come COVID positive in spite of being exposed on OPD basis to 80 to 100 patients every day in last 1 year. Only one pathologist out of these 100 or 110 people came positive, and that too because he was taking methylene blue irregularly, and in between there was a window of exposure. And it's something like a pregnancy pill. If a lady has to take it, has to take it for all the days. If she doesn't take it for 3 days or 4 days and becomes a pregnant, that's not the fault of the medicine, that's the fault of the patient. So I have seen Dr. Golwalkar himself, his staff and the staff around him, 100 to 110 people exposed to 100 patients every day, and in 1 year, none of them have become positive. and even before vaccine. So this is the nebulizer, which is a compressor-based nebulizer. And I have found a small portable nebulizer alternative on Amazon, which is USB rechargeable, has its own battery. And there's a cup in which you can fill methylene blue and Dexona and Duolin if there's an active disease, but only methylene blue if you want just the prevention. So this is a very nice tiny portable nebulizer which you can carry with you in travel. And it gives you 0.3 micron size nebulized particles. And the size of the bronchiole, diameter of the bronchiole is 0.4 microns. So if the particle is size is smaller than bronchiole, it will reach up to alveoli. So this is how you can take the nebulization through the mouth. You can take the nebulization through your nose so that not only nasal cavity, but the paranasal sinuses also will be covered by methylene blue. Only disadvantage of nebulization is that your mouth becomes blue. You wash it immediately after three with water, and in about 3 hours, it goes away. So the nebulization I personally take in the evening, not in the morning. This is available at a cost of around 150 to 300 rupees on Amazon. And here I would like to bring to your notice that we are talking of nebulizer, the cold mist sprayer, not the vaporizer, because vaporizer is a hot steam generator. And methylene blue has a boiling point of 150 degrees and water boils at 100 degrees. So all water will boil before the methylene blue will boil. So what the patient is taking only the plain water steam rather than methylene blue. The vaporizer will work only for volatile oils where the boiling point of those oils like menthol or mint is 70, 60 degrees, which will boil before the water boils, but methylene blue does not boil before the water boils. So vaporizer is no, only cold mist nebulizer, either ultrasonic one or compressor based or ultrasonic one, but no hot steaming. The combination suggested by Dr. Godwalkar, 5 ml of 0.1 methylene blue, 1 ml, correct, sir, please correct me if I'm wrong during the discussion, 1 ml of Duolin or 1 ml of ipratropium bromide and levosalbutamol to dilate the bronchus so that methylene blue can easily go into the alveoli. Now, does it work? This is the question which is asked by medical community. Most of the doctors, about 80% of doctors, are still resistant in their mind. They don't believe that methylene blue really works. They feel that it's just a gimmick. It's a blue magic or blue gimmick. Now, here I would like to answer that of Dr. Godwalkar himself and his staff. As I said, I have observed. I know I have a list of more than 400 MRs who keep visiting. And MRs are the lot of people who are maximally exposed because they visit 20, 30 doctors every day. They are traveling from town to town. They are staying in one hotel today, another hotel tomorrow. The hotels are not five-star. They are usually guest house kind of one-star or two-star where they don't sanitize the rooms. And they are made to sit half an hour, 45 minutes, 30 minutes, 15 minutes in the waiting room of the doctor. So they are maximally exposed people. And I know 400 MRs who have been on methylene blue and none of them have come positive. None of their family members who are methylene blue takers have come positive in last 7 months or 8 months. And some of the MR family members who were not trusting methylene blue for some or the other fear, ashraddha ki wajah se, nahi le rahe the jo family members, wo sab positive hue, ye 7 mahine ke andar, jo le rahe nahi hue. Of 300 families having COVID positive members and their prime contacts, we observed and followed 1500 plus prime contacts, spouse, blood relatives, close relatives living in the same house, grandfather, grandmother, grandchildren. Now, those who were not taking methylene blue, 70% of them came positive in the next 6 to 7 days. Those who took methylene blue, more than 90% of them remained negative. And those 5% who got COVID were very irregular takers and they got the COVID disease, but they had very mild form of disease. So this observation, as well as Dr. Godwalkar, is an example in himself that methylene blue really works and prevents the COVID disease. Now, we did some other experimentation in vitro also to make sure whether it works. This is an experimental trial which we did by using a rapid antigen test kit. Now, what we did was a rapid antigen test detects the spike protein and the surface lipid protein complex specific to SARS-CoV-2. And methylene-2 destroys the spike protein. It also dissolves the lipid layer of the virus and it makes the genome naked. So what theoretically should happen is if we treat the virus with methylene blue, the antigen test should come negative. So that was the hypothesis in my mind. So we did this. So those patients who were positive, we gave them nebulization, we gave them nasal drops, intensive therapy, two times, three times methylene blue, and then we got them tested second day for rapid antigen. And to your surprise, all those patients who were positive on Monday morning would come negative by Tuesday afternoon. Now, next, what we did was a positive patient's right nostril we treated with methylene blue spray, and the left nostril we did not treat. We kept it as a control. And then we took two swabs from right nostril and left nostril, and then these swabs were dipped in the chemical, and then we did the rapid antigen test. So the right nostril, which was treated with methylene blue, gave a negative rapid antigen test, whereas the left nostril, which was not treated, gave a positive antigen test. Now, the next what we did was that of a positive patient, we took two extra swabs, and these two extra swabs were dipped in methylene blue for 4 to 5 minutes to 40 minutes, and then we did these swabs rapid antigen test. And you will be surprised that the same patient swab which were taken straight away and done shown positive, the swab which went into methylene blue cup and then came out and then we did the rapid antigen test, it came negative. This is a proof enough that the methylene blue denatures the spike protein and it dissolves the lipid envelope of the virus within a matter of few minutes. So it definitely works. There is no doubt. There's no need to keep any doubt about it. Now, let us talk about the side effects. Any medication has side effects. There's nothing which is free from side effects. So what are those? So bitter taste for about 1 hour, blue tongue for 4 to 6 hours, nausea, diarrhea, mild rise of skin temperature, because it is a mitochondrial respirator, so it produces so much of ATP in every cell of the body that it produces so much of energy. It is like as if you have run and then stopped, so your body feels the warmth, or as if you have taken intravenous atropine, or as if you have been taking oral steroids, and the warmth which you feel in your body, that kind of warmth you will feel. There is a mild rise of systolic blood pressure because it is vasoconstrictor, it is antihypotensive. So 5 to 10 millimeters of blood pressure may rise. So those who are hypertensive and who are on the antihypertensive medication, they should, or doctor should, monitor their blood pressure and adjust the dose accordingly. There's a mild to moderate irritation for a few minutes after taking the nasal drops. It is as good as oxidizer as a chlorine. So as if you have taken a dip or a dive in a highly chlorinated swimming pool, or jaise naak mein jalan hogi chlorine ki wajah se, aise jalan 15-20 minute ke liye hogi jab aap methylene blue ka inhalation lenge ya to jab aap naak ke andar dalenge. There is no any major adverse side effects which have been known or reported since 1877. Not a single death has been reported by methylene blue anaphylaxis in last 130 years, and it cannot induce anaphylaxis because it is the treatment for reversal of anaphylactic hypovolemic hypotensive shock. So there's no question of it inducing anaphylaxis, it reverses anaphylaxis. This is a very typical side effect which the patients would notice, and we have to inform them that your urine will turn ocean blue color because there's urea in urine and there's blue color, so blue and blue and yellow will make it green. So like Andaman Sea or like Mauritius Sea, the water, the urine becomes green, but patient has to ignore it. There are some advantageous side effects. The sleep requirement decreases because it gives so much of electrons and so much of ATP to the brain that your sleep requirement decreases by 1.5 hours. So if your sleep need is 8 hours, you will be as fresh in 6.5 hours as would be native. The working efficiency increases, mental as well as physical lethargy, fatigue and tiredness feeling is almost gone as if it is evaporated. The pain tolerance increases as well as the physical endurance increases. If you are a fitness freak or a jogging freak, you will never feel tired if you have taken a little Michelin Blue. And in fact, all the mountaineers and all the mountain climbers and high altitude climbers above the 18,000 feet where hypoxia is a typical problem, all those who go on Mount Everest, all those who climb in alpine peaks, they take Michelin Blue with them to prevent hypoxia because of the low oxygen level. It increases your endurance and it also increases the oxygen saturation, and it's very typical for all the mountaineers. They are using Michelin Blue. The mental higher functions, memory and cognition improves. Blood sugar falls by about 50 milligrams to 60 milligrams because Methylene Blue consumes sugar in Krebs cycle to produce ATP. So it will use away some of the excess sugar which the diabetic patient has. So in fact, the diabetic patient gets a little benefit from using Michelin Blue. The mood improves so much that we never feel blue mood or black mood. In fact, Michelin Blue is being used as antidepressant by many psychiatrists and many alternative therapists in Western world. It gives a feeling of innocent bliss, ek nirdosh parmanand ki ek anubhuti jaisi hoti hai, sthit pragna jaisi darshaya jati hai jab lete hain. It gives a sort of a double 007 feeling, which is the feedback given by so many doctors. I ask them, what is 007? What do you mean by 007? So they say that I am feeling after taking Michelin Blue as if I am on cloud 7, as if I am on heavens. And then I ask them, what do you mean by 007? So they say the second feeling is that I am feeling like James Bond. Not only virus, it kills constipation also. And it starts removing the scaling which has been deposited by the commensal bacteria in the mouth. So your teeth becomes white, pyorrhea is gone, dental caries are gone, bad breath, halitosis is gone. The recurrent aphthous ulcer in the mucosa, of the oral mucosa is also gone. And agar raat ko aapne Michelin Blue li hai, you will find that the candida does not grow, the thrush will not be there in the morning. To aap jo tongue cleaning karte hai, ool utarte hai, wo aayegi nahi. There won't be no need to clean your tongue because tongue will be as clean as it was in the night. And I have got about 120 feedback from patients, parents. Now these were the children, 8 year, 12 year. Were posted for tonsil surgery because of chronic tonsillitis going on for last 1 year, 2 years, not responding to any of the antibiotics. And these patients, when they started prophylactic Michelin Blue for prevention of COVID, they found that the tonsils got completely cleared in 2 to 3 days time. And so many nursing staff have given me this feedback that hamare bachcho ko tonsil jo tha nikal gaya 2 hi din mein 3 hi din. Regular use of Michelin Blue will not only prevent COVID, but it will also prevent common cold because it kills the common cold virus. It will prevent influenza. It will prevent dengue, chikungunya, influenza. There is enough literature. If you go on internet, there is free papers against dengue, Michelin Blue against dengue, Michelin Blue against chikungunya, Michelin Blue against influenza, hepatitis B, Nipah, Zika, West Nile. It oxidizes all RNA viruses. All lipid enveloped viruses are oxidized. Urinary tract infection is completely cleared. There will be no pus cell found in the urinary tract. Falciparum vivax malaria will not happen. Senile dementia will be prevented because it prevents the death of the neuron after the age of 60, which is common. Alzheimer's disease is halted or Alzheimer's disease is reversed. It's Michelin Blue is now a part of the protocol of Alzheimer's disease, and it holds also Parkinson and Huntington disease progress. So it has many other advantages also. Now there are many questions which I get after every talk. So let me answer some of those. Can ISB or coronary bypass patient take it? Yes. Can a cancer patient take it? Yes, because in fact, Michelin Blue is a part of the chemotherapy of many types of cancers, especially the breast cancer, prostate cancer, and osteosarcoma. Age limit 6 months onwards up to 100 years, children can be given above the age of six. There are enough publication I'll show you. Pregnant women can take, yes, nebulization and nasal drops and gargling up to the level of tonsil. Pregnant women can also use it to prevent. And chronic renal failure or chronic liver failure, can they take it? Yes, nebulization and nasal drops can be safely taken. Intravenous injection, if has to be used, we have to rule out two things: G6PD deficiency and that there is enough glomerular filtration. So if the eGFR is above 30 ml, we can use. If it is below 30 ml, we should not use. Can we take methylene blue after taking vaccine? Yes, absolutely. We should take, because the vaccine does not protect you 100%. Methylene blue will protect you 99.99%. So it's more powerful as far as taking, as far as the prevention is concerned, than the vaccine itself. So even after taking vaccine, please continue, but just give a gap of 5 to 6 days for the vaccine virus to colonize your body and train your immune system. After that, you can start using it. Stop methylene blue 1 day before and 4 or 5 days after the vaccine shot is taken. Else, methylene blue will oxidize the vaccine viruses also. Are there chances of anaphylaxis? No, because methylene blue is the treatment of anaphylaxis. How long can it be taken? Till the pandemic is over, keep taking. There is no time limit. And I know there are many countries in which methylene blue is taken for the lifelong. Dr. Golwalkar knows several doctors in Armenia and western part of Russia where it's a customary to put methylene blue on the tongue of a newborn child, and they continue till the age of 100. And those communities, they have very high survival rate, 95 years. Plus, Dr. Golwalkar will tell about that discussion which he had with the doctors from Armenia. जैसे हम लोग गुजराती में एक नाम है गलथुथी, मीन्स वी गिव स्वीट वाटर, गुड़ का पानी देते हैं बच्चों को जब जन्म होता है पहले दिन में, तो दे गिव मिथिलीन ब्लू. नाउ विल इट कॉज एनी किडनी डैमेज? नो. विल इट कॉज एनी लिवर डैमेज? नो, इन द डोजेज विच वी रिकमेंड, दैट 5 मिलीग्राम. न्यूरोनल डैमेज? नो, इट्स न्यूरो प्रोटेक्टिव एंड देयर इज इनफ लिटरेचर. देयर इज अ शॉर्ट टर्म बेनिफिशियल इफेक्ट ऑफ मिथिलीन ब्लू on kidney damage in septic shock patients. So it does not damage the kidney. In fact, it reverses the damage to a certain extent of the kidney. Methylene blue improves the hepatopulmonary syndrome. So cirrhosis of liver leading to portal hypertension and hepatopulmonary syndrome, because the fibrosis is broken, the cirrhosis is partly reversed, the portal hypertension is reduced by methylene blue. Well, there's enough literature, you just explore. Methylene blue protects liver oxidative capacity after gut ischemia and reperfusion in the experimental rat model. Neuroprotective effects of methylene blue in vivo and in vitro. It protects the neurons from demyelinating disease. So one of the best use of methylene blue is in recurrent multiple sclerosis. You give recurrent multiple sclerosis methylene blue to patients on recurrent multiple sclerosis, and they regain their sight, because the myelin sheath is regained. I don't know why the COVID the AIIMS team has said that there's no role of methylene blue. Now this paper, I have been asked by everybody that what about this guideline from AIIMS. Now here I would like to clarify 2-3 things. One is that this is a guideline, this is not a guideline, this is not a directive. This is not any kind of official letter. It is just an answer of the FAQs, the frequently asked questions replied by the AIIMS. Now who asked these questions? The ICU experts of AIIMS. There are 17 or 18 AIIMS. In case of ICUs hai, unhone चीफ एम्स को क्वेश्चन पूछे, इसके जवाब इन्होंने दिए हैं. दिस इज नॉट एन ऑफिशियल गाइडलाइन, नंबर वन. और दिस इज द आंसर ओनली फॉर द ईआईसीयूज. इट डज नॉट कंसर्न टू द प्रोफाइलेक्टिक यूज. इट डज नॉट कंसर्न टू द यूज ऑफ द कोविड कोरिजा. नाउ व्हाई दे हैव सेड नो इन स्पाइट ऑफ अवेलेबल लिटरेचर ऑफ 5000 प्लस पेपर्स एंड 18 लाख प्लस रेफरेंसेस, आई डोंट नो. देयर मस्ट बी सम रीजंस for them to keep their eyes shut and remain willful ignorant in spite of so much of literature, so much of trials going on in US, so much of trials going on in Europe and China, ये ऐसी बात है कि आपकी जो मटकी है दिमाग की, अगर आप उल्टी रखेंगे कितनी भी बारिश होगी, मालूम है कि वो भर नहीं भरेगी। अगर आप दिमाग की मटकी चलती रखेंगे तभी वो भरेगी। इनको इससे ज्यादा हम क्या कह सकते हैं। इफ यू गो ऑन वेब एंड जस्ट टाइप मिथिलीन ब्लू रेशनल इन कोविड 19, यू विल फाइंड 48,000 रिजल्ट्स, and there will be so there are so many papers which gives us a good rationale for use of methylene blue. There are some contraindications in first and second trimester of pregnancy, avoid it. In third trimester it can be given if the risk to mother's life is more than the risk benefit ratio, if it is considered in favor of the would be mother rather than the child. Avoiding severe kidney or severe liver failure. Monoamine oxidase inhibitor, because methylene blue itself is monoamine oxidase inhibitor, or serum serotonin reuptake inhibitor. If the patients are on these two groups of antidepressant, when you start methylene blue, reduce the dose of antidepressant. Otherwise, there will be double effect. These patients might sometimes become euphoric and they may take some unwise decisions. I know two patients who took methylene blue when they were taking antidepressant. वो इतने राजापाट में आ गए कि बहुत बड़े बड़े शेयर मार्केट में खरीदी कर लिया जब पैसा घर में नहीं था, और कहीं पे फ्लैट बुक करवा दिया, इतने मतलब बड़े बड़े बिजनेस डिसीजन ऐसे लेने लगे यूफोरिक स्टेट में। G6PD डेफिशिएंसी इज अ नो फॉर आईवी, इट्स अ रिलेटिव कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेशन फॉर ओरल यूज, एंड इट इज यस फॉर नेबुलाइजेशन एंड नेजल यूज। वी कैन गिव इन चिल्ड्रन 6 मंथ्स एंड अबव, अपर एज देयर इज नो बार। As I said, it's a powerful antioxidant. So we need really to open our mind and heart to methylene blue, read about the literature.
Yes,
there is ample literature available. And if we use it in the right context and in the right quantum and in right way, it is so easy and so simple to kill and kick the coronavirus out and end the pandemic. But there is no cure for willful ignorance. And there is no cure for willful blindness. So I urge and I request you all to open your heart and embrace methylene blue. And once you embrace, you will find that it works like a cosmic blue magic, as if it is sent from the heavens. And thank you very much for allowing me the presentation. And now I'll stop sharing my screen. And we have the august presence of Dr. Golwalkar, the Neel Kranti ke praneta. और उनके मुंह से ही और बातें सुनते हैं। आई स्टॉप माय प्रेजेंटेशन हियर एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट द मॉडरेटर टू अनम्यूट डॉक्टर गोलवालकर एंड डॉक्टर शुभा रावल सो दैट क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर सेशन कैन गो। आई वुड आल्सो रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर टू अनम्यूट डॉक्टर रमेश शाह, हु हैज आल्सो जॉइंड, ही हैज आल्सो ट्रीटेड मोर देन 5000 पेशेंट्स प्रोफाइलेक्टिक यूज एज वेल एज थेरेप्यूटिक यूज इन कोविड कोरिजल अर्ली यूआरआई स्टेज। थैंक यू वेरी मच अगेन।
हॅलो, आपल्यामध्ये माननीय आरोग्य मंत्री माननीय राजेशभाई टोपे जी हे आपल्यामध्ये जॉईन झालेले आहेत, त्यामुळे मला असं वाटतं की होस्ट आहेत त्यांनी स्क्रीनवर घ्यावं।
आय रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर आगा सर टू प्लीज फॉलो द
माननीय टोपे साहेब।
रिक्वेस्ट आहे प्लीज व्हिडिओ ऑन करावा।
हो
आहे सर, आहे ऑनलाइन।
हाँ, फक्त त्यांचा व्हिडिओ ऑन नाही झालाय का?
हाँ, व्हिडिओ ऑन नाही आणि म्यूट आहे सर, तर त्यांचे कोणी असिस्टंटला सांगून
हां 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 मी सांगते जरा। हॅलो, तुमचा ऑडिओ आणि व्हिडिओ ऑन करा, तुम्ही जॉईन झालेले दिसतायत पण तुमचा ऑडिओ काय आता जॉईन झालं तर चालेल, कारण लेक्चर संपलेलं आहे आणि हा आणि लगेच ते बोलून हा हा लगेच बोलले तरी चालतील। आम्ही थोडस सांगू ना की ओळख करून देते, डॉक्टर गोलवलकर वगैरे आहे। हो मी केलंय ना.
Can you please unmute Dr. Golwalkar? He wants to give some feedback.
Daga, sir.
How, sir?
Please unmute Dr. Deepak
Golwalkar. Yes, yes, I have made him unmute.
Hello?
Sir. Yes, please, sir.
Dr. Kakadiya has exhaustively, nicely covered all the questions and all the doubts about the methylene blue. I must thank him for a nice presentation. Any doubt?
Yes, Golwalkar sir. You can see the chat box containing many questions, but Dr. Kakadiya sir resolved that was more of the questions, more of the
Anil, Anil sir.
Yes, sir.
Anil sir.
Hi, yes, sir.
आरोग्य मंत्री राजेश भैया टोपे जॉईन झालेले आहेत स्क्रीनवर आपल्याला दिसतायत.
हो हो,
बोलायचं सरांना बोलायचं.
डॉक्टर राजेश भैया टोपे सॉरी श्री राजेश भैया टोपे आरोग्य मंत्री महाराष्ट्र राज्य यांचे एनआयएमए महाराष्ट्र राज्य शाखेद्वारा आणि डॉक्टर काकडिया आणि त्यांची टीम यांच्याद्वारा तसेच डॉक्टर लोंढे सर डॉक्टर शुभा राऊळ मॅडम आयुष टास्क फोर्स यांच्याद्वारा मी त्यांचे सहर्ष स्वागत इथे करत आहे. डॉक्टर राजेश भैया टोपे सर लोंढे सर सर बोलणार आहेत का आताच लगेच
बोलू का
सर बोला.
नमस्कार. आज आयोजित केलेल्या आपल्या या महत्वपूर्ण सेमिनार साठी या ठिकाणी मला खास करून शुभा रावळ मॅडमनी ज्या माझ्या खूप जुन्या स्नेही आहेत आम्ही राज्यमंत्री नगरविकास असताना पासूनची माझी त्यांची खूप जुने स्नेहाचे संबंध आहेत आणि त्यांनी मला नेहमी आपल्या या सगळ्या वेगवेगळ्या आयुष्य ऍक्टिव्हिटीज मध्ये नेहमी सहभागी करून घेतलं होतं. आज सुद्धा त्यांनी मला आवर्जून सांगितलं की मिथाईल ब्लू ही जी काय मेथिलीन ब्लूचा जो आपला प्रयोग झालेला आहे या मेथिलीन ब्लूच्या संदर्भात डॉक्टर गोळवलकर यांनी जो रिसर्च केला किंवा WHO पर्यंत त्यांनी त्यांच्या सगळ्या ज्या काही सक्सेस स्टोरीज आहेत त्या पाठवण्याचं काम केलं मला वाटतं की या सगळ्याच गोष्टी निश्चित प्रकारे या कोविडच्या पार्श्वभूमीवर महत्वाच्या आहेत आणि आरोग्यमंत्री म्हणून मला असं वाटतं की जर त्या सक्सेस स्टोरीजला कुठेतरी एका खात्रीला एक संस्थेच्या माध्यमातून एंडोर्समेंट करून पाहिजे असेल तर त्यासाठी सुद्धा माझा पुढाकार राहील आणि जरूर एवढा जो वापर त्या करतायत मी तर त्यांनी मला सांगितलं मी पण वापर करते. मला वाटतं आता शुभा राऊळ वापर करत असतील तर राजेश टोपेंनी सुद्धा वापर केला पाहिजे कारण तेवढे विश्वासाचे संबंध निश्चित प्रकारे आहेत आणि त्यामुळे जरूर ज्यांच्या ज्यांच्यावर आपला हा वापर झाला असेल मी त्यांना विचारलं की हे प्रोफिलॅक्टिक म्हणून काम करता येईल का क्युरेटिव्ह म्हणून सुद्धा काम करता येईल त्यामुळे दोन्हीच्या दृष्टिकोनातून याचा वापर होऊ शकतो आणि म्हणून मला वाटतं गोळवलकरांनी अतिशय उत्तम काम या सगळ्या कोविडच्या पार्श्वभूमीमध्ये किंवा कोविडच्या परिस्थितीमध्ये केलेलं आहे. मी त्यांचंही मनापासून आभार मानेल आणि त्यांच्या या प्रोडक्टच्या संदर्भात निश्चित प्रकारे माझा आपल्याला एकच सांगणं राहील की मला याच्या बाबतच जे काही माहिती असेल
राजेश भैया टोपे सर सर टोपे सर प्लीज सॉरी फॉर द डिस्टर्बन्स. मी तुम्हाला एक रिक्वेस्ट करतो आपल्या याच्यात आउट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र काही लोक आहेत तर थोडस आपले आरोग्य मंत्री महाराष्ट्राचे खूप सजग आहेत आणि हे आम्हाला माहिती आहे परंतु या लेक्चर वर किंवा याच्यावर किंवा आपलं मत जे मांडताय ते प्लीज जर हिंदी मध्ये असेल फार चांगलं होईल.
नाही जरूर जरूर
थँक्यू सर थँक्यू सर थँक्यू सर थँक्यू सर.
So this sorry actually I was of the opinion that only Maharashtra doctors might have joined in this seminar But I came to know that lot many out of Maharashtra doctors also has taken participation in this seminar. So it's really an honor and a special privilege for me to address this August gathering. And this seminar is going on since two hours. And I think I have joined at the fag end of this seminar. So whatever I have learned from my friend and Dr. Shubha Rahul, ex-mayor of Mumbai, that she has always advocated this methylene blue, and which is researched by Dr. Golwalkar and has been used by not many, used and administered for not many patients. So it's really these success stories should be known to people. And also, I wish that even some government authority should endorse this drug, even if it is a prophylactic or a curative, whatever. I think if it is really useful from the research and from the success stories of the for the patients which has on whom these drugs are administered, I think these success stories should be known to everyone. And as health minister of government of Maharashtra, I will be more than happy to take this ahead in whatever way Dr. Golwalkar and your team wishes. I'm always there to help you, and I'm always really welcoming the innovative ideas which are used in this COVID for the containment of this COVID-19. So once again, I should not take much of your time, because you people are engaged in this seminar since 2-3 hours. So I just wish that this should be taken ahead. Whatever help from my side is required in this regard, I'm always there to help you. And if this magic drug, methylene blue, if it is really working well, I think I will also be speaking to my department's principal secretary. I will also be speaking to some of the people, those who are really connected in this for this drug actually. And so let us see, we will be all in contact through Shubha Rahulji or any of the team members of your from your team. So it's really pleasure for me to join in this seminar and to participate in this seminar and to hear from you, also learn from about this methylene blue. And I will take this ahead, that much I can assure, to this August gathering and all of the doctors, those who have participated. So all my best wishes. Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you, Rajesh Bhaiya ji. Here we have Rajesh Bhaiya ji. आपल्याला सांगावंच वाटतं की आपल्या बरोबर डॉक्टर डेरे पण उपस्थित आहेत. जर ते उपस्थित असतील, कारण ते ही इज हँडलिंग बीकेसी कोविड विच इज हायली लोडेड अँड नाव ही इज ट्रीटिंग देअर आयसीयू पेशंट्स, 300 आयसीयू पेशंट्स विथ मिथेलिन ब्ल्यू, आय व्ही मिथेलिन ब्ल्यू गिविंग, ही इज गिविंग देअर. सो इफ ही इज देअर इन अवर मीटिंग, please appear on screen as we want your guidance also. Dr. Kakariya ji also with us, Dr. Ramesh Shah from Mumbai, eye surgeon, he is also with us. They are all spreading the message throughout the world of methylene blue. It is really a magic drug. I am also appreciating, and I am also applying on me. Here I am having Rajesh Bhaiya ji, tumhala dakhavte रोज घेते. आणि ऑल्सो
किती प्रमाणात, हाऊ मच इज द क्वांटिटी दॅट यू हॅव टू टेक?
ओनली only half the chamach to be taken sublingually. Below the tongue, we have to taken once only. It is very much effective. Aplyala evda oxygen level vadte in our body. We feel very energetic. Not only helping to prevent the corona infection, but also helping us in body. Dr. Golwalkar ji, you can also say something because you are the pioneer of this thing. Dr. Golwalkar ji boltil tanna
agdi short nutshell madhe zarur Golwalkar ji sanga.
मी ते एकच सांगेन की आधा चम्मच जबान के अंदर करानो का करे चुमन मी सगळे स्टार्ट यूजिंग इन द मासेस यू कैन स्लीप कामली अंडरनीथ द ब्लू स्काय आई विल दैट माय ड्रीम दैट इफ यू स्टार्ट यूजिंग इन मासेस नॉट इन इंडिविजुअल और इफ यू स्टार्ट यूजिंग इन मासेस यू स्लीप नाइसली यू कैन हैव अ साउंड स्लीप under the blue sky. That's my dream, and if it is, I hope you will fulfill my dream.
Surely I will start using. I wish that Dr. Shubha Rahul ji should provide me on Tuesday, because tomorrow evening flight I will be coming to Mumbai. At present I am in Jalna, and I hope that I will get that and I will start using from Tuesday.
Yes thank you. And we are having our host Dr. Sanjay Londe ji and Dr. Daga ji, Dr. Bajare ji. They are all from NEMA Association. And Mayuri, hey la, battery la.
Shubhaji, I'll take the leave. Thank you.
Definitely, we will meet on Tuesday.
Surely.
On behalf of NEMA, thank you, Rajesh Bhaiya ji.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
आता डॉक्टर डेरे आलेले आहेत का?
काय नावानी आहे मॅडम? डेरे नावानी पण नाही आहे.
डॉक्टर राजेश डेरे.
लोंडे सर, तुम्ही बोललात होता. लोंडे सर.
डॉक्टर संजय तू बोल.
शुभ राजीव डॉक्टर आहेत का? डेरे सर असतील तर त्यांना बोलू देतो.
क्वेश्चन
आन्सर.
राजेश डेरे नावानी नाही आहे.
आहे ते बीकेसी मध्येच आहेत. बघूया जॉईन होऊ शकले नसतील कदाचित. ठीक आहे, ते फोन उचलत नाहीये. आता ते फोन उचलत नाही तोपर्यंत आपण कंटिन्यू करूया.
थिंग आय वुड लाईक टू से अबाउट द आयव्ही मिथिलिन ब्लू. वेन यू गिव्ह आयव्ही मिथिलिन ब्लू, अनफॉर्च्युनेटली यू गिव्ह इन अ व्हेरी लास्ट स्टेज. इफ यू गिव्ह इट अर्लियर विल गो डाऊन. पण काय होतं की वेन द हायपोक्सी इज सिव्हिअर, यू ब्रिंग गिव्ह आयव्ही मिथिलिन ब्लू, ऑक्सिजन लेवल विल गो अप. But at the same time, you have to start giving a nebulization, because unless and until lungs get clear, the oxygenation will not improve. Again, the patient become worsened. So both things have to be started at the same time and give IV along with nebulization. And nowadays, I'm using 3% hypertonic saline to break down the mucus plug. That is also helping me quite a lot. That is helping in clearing the mucus plug or mucus with secretion over the bronchi.
No, I could not get it. Which saline to be given?
3% hypertonic saline. It is a mucolytic in nebulization.
Okay.
Because actually these mucus plugs, the secretion are so sticky and they block the alveolar capillary block. And unless and until they are removed, with IV methylene blue, you improve the oxygenation, oxygen saturation goes up, but because lungs are not transporting oxygen again, so again, worsen. Unfortunately, till now, I get a call with a patient in the last stage. They ask me to give IV methylene blue, they give it, and then they say that we didn't get good results. But start it earlier, but at the same time start giving nebulization also. You have to clear the lungs because the oxygen supply from the lung should improve at the same time. Then only you get good results.
Okay. And what is the perfect time to use IV methionine blue? What is the perfect time? Not too very early, not too late.
See, patients, if they don't respond within 2 days to sublingual and nebulization, that is the perfect time, in my opinion. Not okay. Wait 7 days or 8 days till the patient stops responding to any other therapy. So after 2 days, it is you must give IV methionine blue.
Okay.
Nebulization is must, clearing the lung is must.
Yeah. And IV methionine blue can be given in OPD basis also, no? There is no harm to give.
No, for that it can be given, but you have to keep the patient at least for 4 hours in your OPD.
Yeah, yeah.
You have to rule out G6PD deficiency and renal function you have to clear out. And after giving, you have to keep it at least for 4 hours. But sublingual, in my experience, sublingual and nebulization is enough.
Okay. They
do routinely on this. If the oxygen saturation is 90 or above, then they don't require any admission. If it is below 90, then it is a danger line.
Okay. So after getting 90 level, we should think of admit in the hospital, and after that immediately we can start methylene blue IV.
Yes, we can. Only one shot is enough in this.
One shot along with nebulization. Yeah.
Along, yes, nebulization is must because we have to clear the lung. IV methylene blue will bring out the oxygen level, but till lungs are not helping them to give oxygen, enough oxygen to maintain the oxygen level, then methylene blue only itself will not work because it will bring down the viral load, it will improve the oxygenation, but the supply from the lung is to be there. For that, clearing of the lung is very essential.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I am going there. I think Dr. If possible, Dr. Ramesh Shah will be joining me to Health Minister. So we can explain him very much more deeper.
Sir, how do you prepare the hypo 3% solution of normal saline?
No, it is available in the market. It is recommended for mucolytic, as a mucolytic. In hyponatremia, it is they are using for medical purpose, but it is officially accepted solution for mucolytic, as a mucolytic. In TB, we always use since years to bring out sputum in nebulized form. Hypotonic saline is recommended, officially accepted, and in documented as a mucolytic.
Okay. Thank
sir,
you.
For nebulization, how it could be used?
5 milliliter every, depending on the severity. 4 hourly, 6 hourly, it can be given, no problem. I am giving in depending on the condition, the seriousness of the situation, you can give extra, no problem. 4 hourly also I have to give. Yesterday only I had to give 4 hourly. By evening, patient responded and he became all right.
Sorry, as it's a half life is too low, is it safe to use a half year or 1 year? Safe? Is it safe?
Children.
Children's below 5 years, I recommend nebulization. In case if the parents, a few days back, I had a couple with a child.
No. Sorry to disturb you. The duration.
Duration can be used for 1 year.
The duration. See, in interstitial lung diseases and fibrotic lung conditions, I have used for a year, no problem. Till lungs got cleared, I'm using for 1 year nebulization, no problem. I've been using fibrotic condition, interstitial lung disease, even 1 year, they are doing very well, no side effect. No toxicity, no problem.
And the sublingual and oral use?
Sublingual, you can continue till the pandemic is over. And oral sublingual, you can continue. I am taking for other reason since 2 years. When corona was not there, still I am taking because there is some other beneficial effect. to get that benefit, I am taking it personally.
Dr. Kakadia wants to say something because he has raised his hand. Please unmute him, please. Something he wants to say.
Yeah, sir, the hypertonic saline are available, Dr. Golwalkar, sir, and Dr. RC, as 3% and 5%. So you recommend which 3%?
Yes.
Okay. Because 5% is also available as small quantity as eye drops. And how many ml, 5 ml in a nebulization cup?
ML. 5 ml, 6 hourly, depending on the severity, how bad patient is. Even 4 hourly I am using in some conditions till the patient start bringing out sputum.
Okay, and do you add methylene blue to that hypertonic saline or only hypertonic saline?
No, that separately I am giving. I am not adding to that thing, separately I am giving.
Okay.
Sir, it is same as surgeon use to demarcate the disease part?
Yeah, same one. Actually, I started with the bronchopleural fistula 1978. We used to use in chest wall in intubated patient, and we used to ask the patient to lie down and cough it out. But there I had noticed that those patients where I tried to diagnose bronchopleural fistula, the pulmonary resolution was very fast. I had noticed it, then I forgot. But then when I started nebulizer therapy in Gujarat in 1989, first time, I had a dream to treat TB with nebulization. I was giving a thought to that thing. That time I remembered that I had noticed that resolution in intubated patient where I used for diagnosing bronchopleural fistula. So I tried it and I started getting good results. That's how I had started.
Sir, regarding the asthma patient, do it is recommended for that?
Yes. Very good question. Actually, nowadays using hot to bring down the fibrosis, and it has very strong antifibrotic activities. My patients are happy after starting using nebulization with methylene blue. They are benefited. I am collecting data on that thing, but clinical experience, I can say that they are very much happy after starting in getting nebulization with methylene, because actually it has very strong antifibrotic activity. So that benefit I'm getting out of it.
And hence in the COPD also. COPD,
COPD. Yes. Actually, this COPD means very bad asthmatic emphysematous with bullous formation is there. There I don't get result. But in case if there is no bulla formation, yes, definitely 15 to 20% improvement is there.
Sir, there are much more questions in the chat box. But before that, I would like to know, in COVID situation, there are many legal aspects. What about the methylene blue's legal aspect to use by GPs or by all doctors in the view of COVID?
See, we are using in bronchopleural fistula. We are giving IV methylene blue. We are using in vesico-vaginal fistula. We are using in peritoneal wash. We are using in post-cardiac surgery wash. We are using in knee joint injury. We are using in breast injury. Abscess to demarcate the lining. We are using in oral local application. And I got a paper from Erlangen. There, they found that it could stain the cancer cells in the intestine with the methylene blue. So they tried it with after bronchoscopy. They tried to stain the bronchogenic carcinoma, but they said that this procedure was accepted by Erlangen University Ethical Committee. But the results which they got in intestinal cancer were not that satisfactory in bronchogenic carcinoma. So it is in all over the body, when it is acceptable, I don't think any problem should be raised.
Dr. Sachin Jain wants to ask it.
No, sir, I'm not a doctor, but main Golwalkar ji se ye puchna chahta hu. कि मैं पिछले 4 महीने से मैं और मेरा पूरे परिवार के हम लोग इसे यूज कर रहे हैं, लेकिन मैंने मेरे मदर फादर को वैक्सीन भी लग गया है और मुझे जानकारी नहीं थी, और लेकिन हम फिर भी उसे यूज करते रहे, तो क्या वो जो वैक्सीन लगाई है वो क्या वेस्ट हो गई है?
नहीं, एंटीबॉडी चेक कर लो, एंटीबॉडी टाइटर चेक कर लीजिए, अगर है तो दैट इज गुड, एंटीबॉडी टेस्ट चेक कर लीजिए आप।
और अगर अगर नहीं है तो क्या वैक्सीन क्या डबल से लगवाएं फिर?
तो आपके पास मिथिलिन भी है ना, आप चिंता क्यों करते हो?
ओके, थैंक यू।
सर, कैन यू शो डेमोंस्ट्रेशन ऑफ अ नेबुलाइजर, हाउ टू मेक अ नेबुलाइजर, बिकॉज़ अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर देयर रिगार्डिंग द नेबुलाइजर।
यस, इट देयर इज इन एन
डायरेक्ट दैट एम्पुल द मिथिलिन ब्लू एम्पुल टू बी इंसर्टेड इन द चेंबर ऑफ द नेबुलाइजर और इट शुड बी डाइल्यूटेड।
No, 0.1% Dr. Kakadi has that video. 0.1% solution can be put to be put in the chamber and nebulize it, take it the nebulization. Dr. Kakadi has shown that video of that nebulizer.
Rahul madam, tumchakade ahe tar please.
Ha, ye ahe.
Madam kade jaye. Ha.
Ye ahe. Ani mee roz jeva
kundi madhe madam please, if possible.
मयुरी इकडे ना, जेव्हा जेव्हा मी कोविड सेंटरला विजिट देते क्या क्वारंटाइन सेंटरला विजिट देते, जब जब मैं कोविड सेंटर से आती हूँ तब मैं ये मिथिलिन ब्लू सॉल्यूशन जो पीने के लिए बनाया है वो ही सॉल्यूशन 1.5 चमचा इसमें डालती हूँ इसके चेंबर में, जैसे मैंने पहले लेक्चर में डॉक्टर काकड़िया जी से सुना था। ये मैंने डाला हुआ है मिथिलिन ब्लू 7.5 ml यानी 1.5 चम्मच, उसके बाद उसको बंद करना है। इस तरह से उसको बंद करना है और इसको ऑन करना है। इस तरह से इसको आप माउथ पीस भी है, माउथ पीस भी अगर लगाते हो तो उसके नोज में और इसे नाक में दोनों बाजू से 3-3 बार और मुंह में डालकर आप उसे होल्ड भी कर सकते हैं। आप देख सकते हैं इट इज वेरी इजी, और इसको आप फिर ऐसे ही रख दे सकते हैं। ये आपको धोके रखना है, ये और ये धोके रखना है, क्योंकि हमारे घर में 2 जन यूज करते हैं, मैं और मेरी लड़की है जो KEM में अभी उसका MD चालू है पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन, वो भी जब भी आती है तब ये इस तरह से मिथिलिन ब्लू का नेबुलाइजेशन यूज करती है। और इट इज वेरी इजी, सिर्फ आपके मुंह में ये ब्लू टिंट आ जाता है, उसको आप धो के यूज कर सकते हैं।
ग्रेट, रिगार्डिंग वन क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग द टैबलेट्स, डू टैबलेट्स आर इजीली अवेलेबल इन मार्केट एंड व्हाट शुड बी द डोज?
Not capsules and tablets are available only in USA. In India, it's still not available.
So Kakri, we are only
Kakri sir told about the Sitopladi tablet.
Yes, and
the combination.
I mean, that's a homemade. I mean, Sitopladi or either or Septilinia. Any you can even take calcium sendos. Yeah, koi bhi hygroscopic tablet jo hai, even you can impregnate vitamin C. Any tablet which will absorb or which is mouth dissolving will absorb it. So you can just put 0.4 ml of the injection itself. That will be 4 mg. So tablet bana sakte hain khud, but available nahi hai. India mein nahi available. There is a mithilin blue tablet available in India, but that is not for human consumption. It is for the dairies to test the quality of milk. Because with how much lactic acid is there in the milk is titrated by using methylene blue tablet, but that's for the dairy industry, not for human consumption.
One more interesting question regarding the type 2 diabetes. As you are told, it is a hypoglycemic agent, so it should be given in type 2 diabetes.
No, not as a primary therapy. It is an, I mean, what I meant to say was, kafi logo ko mujhe question ye karte hain log, ki diabetes wale lenge to diabetes inka badh jayega kya? So it is not a drug which will induce a higher level of sugar. It will in fact reduce the sugar level. So it is helpful in diabetes, but it cannot be used as a primary anti-diabetic agent for those who are already on drug. If there's a patient who is on borderline and who wants not to start the routine diabetic medication, he can take because the sugar will be reduced by 40 milligrams.
One important thing I would like to say, those who are prone to diabetic, if they develop corona, the sugar level goes up. And don't treat these patients with oral antidiabetic, treat with insulin only, because the if you don't control the sugar, corona medicines do not work. So you bring down the control the sugar with insulin only, no tablets.
Yes. Means I have to monitor during the.
So presently, then we have only two options: inhaler and oral sublingual with gargling and intake. IV methylene blue injectable IV. When should be you recommended administered, and what precaution should be taken?
Yes. Three way we can use it to bring down the number of patients. Use in masses prophylactic sublingual and nasal drops. If the patient develops corona, start with nebulization and sublingual. And if the patient is worsening, then give him IV methylene blue. But same time, clear the lung with what I said, that nebulization with methylene blue, Dextona, Duolin, there are some questions where there is silent chat, why to use it. But my experience says there are few ronchi. Interleukins have absorbed or used, corona has utilized all the interleukins, so you don't get bronchospasm. But there are, I can hear few ronchi. Few ronchi are there, so I feel that by adding to that thing, Duolin or Combi meals, we don't lose anything, but it is a beneficial advantageous effect. So first thing, first line should be to give sublingual to the masses and nasal drops. Second, give nebulization, IV required. And third thing, post-COVID fibrosis. I will call it not as a fibrosis, but I will call it as in my experience that interstitial pneumonitis. That gets cleared in 2.5 months. I have a number of X-rays preserved with me. And nobody will, if you start in using it, patient will can prevent the lung transplantation. None of my patient has been subjected to lung transplantation. They complete the 6 minute walk test, those who are not able to walk 20 meters, or in case if they come to me with 95% oxygen saturation, after 20 meter walk, if it goes down to 85, they get clear within 1.5 to 2.5 months maximum. It is interstitial pneumonitis. This methylene blue has tremendous potential to clear it. So you can avoid lung transplantation in all these patients.
Sir, one question regarding mucormycosis. Your experience regarding fungal infection.
After I have started using the methylene blue, it itself is a very strong antifungal. Hardly I have come to know about it. Come across any patient with mucormycosis, because right from the first day I start using this therapy. So that is avoided. In case if the patient comes late to me, then I have to deal with them. But otherwise, initial, when patient comes to me right from the first day, none of them they डेवलप में कर मैं तो
सर एज अ वैक्सीनेशन ड्राइव इज देयर ऑन फुल स्पीड योर रिकमेंडेशन और योर से रिगार्डिंग व्हेन टू अवॉइड इन द पीरियड ऑफ वैक्सीनेशन
See, 1 to 3 days prior and 7 days, 5 to 7 days after the vaccination. But then after vaccination, start taking within due. Because there are some incidences of post-vaccination patient, people are developing corona. They say that it may be mild form, but I don't want even 10% loss. Why to suffer even 10% loss of your lung unnecessarily, which can be avoided. So after 5 to 7 days, as Dr. Kakde had said, start taking methylene blue, so even 10% losses can be avoided. In young age, even 10% loss is major loss to anybody. And it is avoidable. So start taking after second for dose of vaccination. So that problem can be avoided. Dr. Kakadi has the list of the doctors who developed corona after vaccination. In these conditions, if you start taking methylene blue, it can be avoided.
Out of 400 doctors I know of Bhavnagar IMA, who all took both the doses of vaccine, 40 doctors came positive within a month or so. And two needed ICU admission and one had to be kept on BiPAP for about a week. So the vaccine is not foolproof. It's giving you a protection rate of about 70%. Although it prevents the mortality, that's fine. But it does not prevent the infection in at least about 10 out of 100 would still get after vaccine. So it's definitely a better idea to continue methylene blue even after vaccination. Just we want to make sure that the vaccine viruses are not destroyed by methylene blue before our immune system learns to identify them. So keep a window of 1 or 2 days before your date of taking vaccine and 4 to 5 days after taking your vaccine. Because in 5 days time, your lymphocytes will learn and those viruses are anyway no more. So just continue methylene blue till the pandemic is over, even if you have taken vaccine.
Dr. Ramesh Shah.
Please unmute him.
Yeah, already he is unmuted.
No, he's not.
Okay.
His mic shows red. Now you are unmuted, Dr. Ramesh.
Bolo sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Your experience regarding the methylene blue and COVID.
See, we have distributed a lot of methylene blue in Mumbai. I think so. Dr. Sulbha also has taken from me and she's distributing on our behalf to all the BMC staff recently. And I have been doing for last about 13 months with the help of Dr. Golwankar and Dr. Kakadia both. And we have treated more than 5,000 patients so far. None of the patients has been admitted so far. We started giving nebulizer also in all the positive patients, depending on the severity as per Dr. Golwalkar's recommendation. And almost all of them are getting cured with methylene blue. Previously, we are using UV light, but since the methylene blue has come, all UV light has almost disappeared. We hardly use UV light for that. So now we are using methylene blue. One more thing is that I have made a small lotion on the face as an anti-aging cream, and about 5 to 6 people of my family are using it, including myself. So let's see how it works. Second thing is I am using the similar lotion which I made so that we started using in herpetic lesion on the face also, and that has given a wonderful results along with the UV light. I treated about 4 to 5 patients so far, and the herpetic lesion disappeared in 3 days. And there is no subsequent pain so far, and no scarring yet. And if you see after 10 days, sometimes it is difficult to find where the lesion has been in the past. So methylene blue, as per, I think it's a very important drug for all of us, unfortunately in Maharashtra is not as popular as in Gujarat. So we'll trying our level best with the help of Dr. Surbha and other lot of Gujarati organization has approached me for supplying the methylene blue, which we are purchasing from E-Mark, laboratory grade of 96% purity, and recommending them to use this as per Dr. Galwankar's recommendation. And we are getting little shortage of methylene blue injection in Mumbai. And unfortunately, they have increased the charges from 95 rupees to 225 rupees in last 3 months. So our experience has been extremely good. I am also taking it regularly. I take twice a week nebulizer because of my exposure to a lot of patients which I see per day.
One more interesting question is there in chat box that as you had told that methylene blue cost has increases in the same way, if we popularize this treatment, nebulizer cost may be get increased. If people doesn't have nebulizer in rural places, can it can be administered in hot water as we take weeks garam pani ke saath mein?
The boiling temperature, methylene blue boiling temperature is more than water. So if you boil the water, the methylene blue will remain down, only water will go up.
Then what substitute to the nebulizer if in rural places people don't have a nebulizer machine with them?
There is no substitute.
And nebulizer costs only 160 rupees, the portable which...
Portable one.
The one which I have shown. So I don't see any rational ki koi aadmi 160 rupees ka nebulizer nahi khareed sakta hai. Aur agar nahi khareedega to usko 1.5 lakh rupiya remdesivir ke piche kharch karna hai. To aap choose kar lo ki aapne 200 rupiye ka remdes 200 rupiye ka ek nebulizer aur 200 rupiye ki methylene blue leni hai ki 2 lakh rupiya jaake ICU mein bharna hai.
See, one thing is there that rural people must understand now that they can't go on begging everything. They have to make an attempt to get things done themselves also.
और मैं ये बोलूं सर कि जो इलेक्ट्रिक वेपराइजर आ रहा है जिससे कि आप इलेक्ट्रिक से स्टीम प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हो वो 400 रुपए का है और नेबुलाइजर जो है वो 170 रुपए का है.
नो नो जस्ट इट्स अ अवेलेबिलिटी. इफ इट इज नॉट अवेलेबल देन आई एम फॉर दैट
पीपल
I have made him unmute. Yes, Dr. Pradnya.
अच्छा डॉक्टर डेरे सुधा आता बहुतेक जॉइन होता है का?
हाँ यस मैडम.
हाँ डॉक्टर प्रज्ञा बोलता है का?
डॉक्टर आलोक इज देयर. आलोक मोर
सर प्रणाम गोवलकर साहब एंड सभी डॉक्टर्स को मेरा बहुत बहुत प्रणाम. और मैं आपको बताना चाहूंगा कि आज से हमने गांधीधाम में मिथिलिन ब्लू का कैंपेन स्टार्ट कर दिया है और फर्स्ट लॉन्च डॉक्टर धैवत मेहता जो IMA प्रेसिडेंट है और इस समय लाइव यूट्यूब पे हमें देख रहे हैं वो उनके संग हमने आज स्टार्ट कर दिया है और ग्रेजुअली हम इसमें जाएंगे. और आपसे मैं जानना चाहूंगा क्या आप गांधीधाम IMA एसोसिएशन के संग एक वेबिनार अरेंज कर पाएंगे अगर वो डिमांड करते हैं?
We are at your service 24/7 if we can save few more patients.
Thank you very much sir.
गोलवालकर सर शायद
yes.
ये 9 बजे से रात को 12:30 बजे तक क्लिनिक में रहते हैं. आज तो संडे है इसलिए अब कैचअप कर लिया है.
बस साहब का मैं आज आशीर्वाद लेने के लिए आया था आपके संग. तो गोवालकर साहब का मुझे आशीर्वाद.
एक ही रीजन होता है मैं इतना कंटिन्यू करता हूँ. आई डोंट वांट टू पर लेकिन क्या होता है कि मेरे को मालूम है कि आज RT-PCR पॉजिटिव है. अगर मैं कल सुबह उसको देखने जाऊंगा तो 95 में से ऑक्सीजन सैचुरेशन विल गो डाउन टू 90. सो आई मे हरी टू गिव नेबुलाइजेशन एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल टू द पर्सन हु हैज कम टू मी विद RT-PCR. एक बार नेबुलाइजेशन दे देता हूँ तो आई नो कि अब मैं साइटोकाइन स्टॉर्म का भी प्रिवेंट कर दिया है. अब नाउ आई डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट पेशेंट. लेकिन अगर मैं आज उसको नहीं बोलता हूँ आई डोंट मीन्स आई एम 69 मेरे को इतनी इच्छा भी नहीं होती है. लेकिन मेरे को ये मालूम है कि मेरे पास आए और अगर मैं उसको नेबुलाइजेशन नहीं दूंगा तो टुमारो ही विल कम इन ए बैड शेप. सो टू अवॉइड दैट थिंग आई keep on continuing.
सर मैं भगवान से ये प्रार्थना करूंगा कि सभी डॉक्टर को आप जैसा सोच और विचार दे. मैं सैल्यूट करता हूं आपको सर, आपकी सोच को. आप इस धरती पे आज भगवान स्वरूप हैं सर.
भैया गुरु गुरु
I do have a question regarding nebulization. Sir, I am listening to your lecture. Is it like that that for prevention we have to use methylene blue 5 ml for nebulization, and for treatment of positive patient we have to use 5 ml of methylene blue plus duolin plus dexamethasone? Are you suggesting like that? And my, yes. I have again a question, sir, that if dexamethasone, can we use it in the first week? Is it okay with it or not?
Absolutely. We have to first stop the cytokine storm.
Yes, sir.
Dexamethasone and methylene blue, they are the drug which are helping us. If you avoid it and if you land in cytokine storm, then you are in trouble. Then it takes, patient is in trouble and you are also in trouble. Immunity wise, if you say it doesn't cause any damage, but inhalation form, you have to give, that only will block the development of the cytokine storm. That will stop the release of amines, interleukins, and if it leaks into the bronchi, then you are in trouble.
Okay. Sir, I do have again a question. In regular practice, 5 compressor nebulizer, do you change mask for each and every patient for nebulization of the patient, or do you use any other technique?
See, as you must have seen that Dr. Kakde has shown, I made one hole in my nebulizer with 18 number needle. So okay. She was 6 inches away, 8 inches away from the patient, and it comes dead. So after every nebulization, I don't use mask because I have to use in everybody. So it keeps 6-8 inches away. You can see it again if you want to see it, and it comes in jet, so it doesn't cross infect. And at the same time, I dip it in Dettol solution, again repeat with the other patient. So I don't use mask for that reason only. I have 18 inches with 18 number needle, and it comes in jet.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. There is just one question. I'm bothering you a little bit. But sorry, sir. Thank you very much.
I use a UV chamber. I use UV chamber to sterilize this mask.
Okay.
Those who have missed Dr. Kakadia's lecture today's, or they may have some confusion, they can watch this lecture on YouTube. Link already shared on the chat box. Dr. Sachin is there.
Yeah, I wish Dr. Sachin be unmuted. He wants to share his experience and his family's experience about methylene blue. Please, Dr. Sachin Bhagat.
Yes, sir. I'm very thankful to Dr. Kakadia sir, Dr. Durgulka sir, Arinch kiya tha ek bar. Kakadia sir was there. Hello.
Yes, we can hear you.
Hello, I am audible.
Sachin, yes, go ahead.
Yes, sir. So, on that day, जिस दिन वेबिनार हुआ था उसी दिन मेरे फैमिलीज के कुछ मेंबर पॉजिटिव आए थे जिनके कांटेक्ट में मैं खुद था. ऑन दैट सेम डे आई वेंट बैक फ्रॉम नागपुर एंड दे ऑल वर पॉजिटिव ऑन मंडे. दैट डे वॉज संडे एंड आई स्टार्टेड मिथिलीन ब्लू ऑन मंडे एंड आई डिड माई सेल्फ माई आरटीपीसीआर ऑन थर्सडे. It was totally negative, and my brother-in-law also was with me, and both were negative, and all the members were positive. That was my first experience with methylene blue, and after that, I have used this in many my neighbors, my patients. As I am an ophthalmologist, I am not using it as a GP practitioner or general practitioner, but it's very helpful, very very much helpful. Sir, अभी का एक जो मेरा questions था जो डोजिंग के बारे में, तो अभी 5 ml राइट नाउ दिस कोविड वेरिएंट इज वेरी वायरल. तो मुझे पूछना था सर आपसे कि अभी का जो डोजिंग है वो नेबुलाइजेशन में 5 ml डेली देना है क्या?
या इफ यू आर एक्सपोज्ड देन पेशेंट 5 ml डेली.
सर जो 3% नॉर्मल सलाइन है उसका अलग से बीबी या 4 आवरली 3 आवरली एज पर सीवियर
डिपेंडिंग. यस यस पेशेंट का हाइपोक्सिक कंडीशन रेस्टलेस तो गो ऑन रिपीटिंग 6 आवरली 4 आवरली जब पेशेंट भी से कि सब मेरी अपनी खुली हो गई है, आई कैन ब्रीद इन नाउ. पेशेंट सब्जेक्टिव फेनोमेना इज बीइंग कॉन्फिडेंट. पेशेंट विल से कि आई एम फीलिंग रिलैक्स्ड. यू कैन सी फ्रॉम हिज फेस दैट ही इज नाउ रिलैक्स्ड.
डॉक्टर मोहन यंडे
सर नमस्कार. मला क्वेश्चन टास्क फोर्स मेंबरला विचारायचं आहे की आपल्याकडे सध्या जे काही म्हणजे प्रोटोकॉल फॉलो केला जातात आहे. हा हा येस येस सर. मेरा क्वेश्चन टास्क फोर्स मेंबर से है राहुल मॅडम और संजय सर से की अभी जो महाराष्ट्र में जो प्रोटोकॉल मोस्ट ऑफ द हॉस्पिटल कोविड हॉस्पिटल में यूज किया जा रहा है उसमें दूसरे कोई जो प्रोटोकॉल है उसके बियॉन्ड जाकर कोई ऐसे अल्टरनेट मेडिसिन या आयुर्वेद मेडिसिन देने को भी वो रिफ्यूज करते हैं. इवन मैंने आज एक आयुर्वेदिक हॉस्पिटल जहाँ कोविड सेंटर है उसके नोडल ऑफिसर से बात किया तो वो भी बोला कि सर कलेक्टर ने जो बताया है उसके हिसाब से ही हमें चलना है. तो इन दैट केस जब भी बाजारे सर ने एक लीगल आस्पेक्ट क्वेश्चन किया था तो मेरा ये डायरेक्टली क्वेश्चन टास्क फोर्स मेंबर से है कि ये जो चीजें हम करेंगे या कोविड हॉस्पिटल्स में या इवन अपने ओपीडीज में तो इसका कोई लीगल स्टैंड या कोई मेडिको लीगल जो इश्यू है इसका वो क्या रहेगा अभी.
नहीं अगर आप प्राइवेट ओपीडी में या प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल में करना यूज करना चाहते हैं मिथिलीन ब्लू तो आप पेशेंट का कंसेंट लेके कर सकते हैं. अदरवाइज इट हैज गॉट नो साइड इफेक्ट सो यू कैन यूज इट वेरी फ्रीली. बट इफ यू वांट टू आपको अगर आयुष के कोई मेडिसिन को नए से अदर देन प्रोटोकॉल अगर यूज करना है तो आपने एथिकल कमिटी होती है आजू बाजू में कोई भी इंस्टीट्यूट रहेगा या कॉलेज मेडिकल कॉलेज रहेगा आयुर्वेद या होम्योपैथी वहां पर एथिकल कमिटी रहती है. एथिकल कमिटी में आपका प्रस्ताव डालना है और विद इन 3 days यू विल गेट द नो ऑब्जेक्शन सर्टिफिकेट टू मेक क्लिनिकल ट्रायल्स. और उसके बाद अगर वो सर्टिफिकेट आ गया उसके बाद आपको जिस पेशेंट पे आपको ये देना है 10 या 12 पेशेंट पे उनकी NOC कंसेंट होनी चाहिए. यस वी आर अवेयर ऑफ दिस ड्रग एंड वी आर रेडी टू यूज इट इन अवर क्लिनिकल ट्रायल. तो ये आप इतना करते हैं तो आप आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम लीगल प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगा.
शुभ राहुल मैडम है अपने साथ तो नो इश्यू ऑफ लीगल इश्यू.
डॉक्टर फाल्गुनी ठाकर ठक्कर.
हेलो.
हाँ बोलिए मैडम.
हेलो सर. एज ए प्रोफाइलेक्टिक यूज में सबलिंगुअल कितना डोज देना है. एज माय सन इज एनेस्थेटिस्ट एंड एवरीडे इज गोइंग कोविड आईसीयू इंट्यूबेट भी करना पड़ता है तो उनको जैसे एज ए प्रोफाइलेक्टिक के डोज में मैं सबलिंगुअल कितना दे सकती हूँ. हेलो.
हाँ यस मैडम. इसका आंसर एक मैं देना चाहूंगा कि वीडियो में आप गए तो आपको काकड़िया सर का वीडियो में आप ठीक से मेंशन है उसका डोज मेंशन है और उसका जो लिक्विड
प्रिपेयर करना है
तो ये वीडियो यूट्यूब पे है
सर. आता डॉक्टर डागा जी आता अपने बरोबर डॉक्टर डेरे आहे. डॉक्टर डेरे अपने साथ में है. उन्होंने बहुत सक्सेसफुली 300 पेशेंट में आईवी मिथिलीन ब्लू बीकेसी सेंटर में यूज किया है तो वो अपना यहाँ पर एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करेंगे. उसके बाद हम थोड़ा क्वेश्चन आंसर रखेंगे. डॉक्टर गोलवलकर जी तुम्ही पण ऐकून घ्या म्हणजे तुमच्या मार्गदर्शन आपके मार्गदर्शन के अंडर ही हम चल रहे हैं और डॉक्टर डेरे ने उसको आईसीयू में आईवी प्रिपरेशन यूज किया है. डॉक्टर डेरे आपण आहात का.
मॅडम काय नावानी आहे ते.
डॉक्टर राजेश डेरे.
नाही मॅडम त्या नावानी नाही.
हॅलो
गेले. ठीक है. आणखीन कोणाला प्रश्न किसी को प्रश्न पूछने हैं तो आप पूछ सकते हैं. डॉक्टर
हेलो. हेलो. इट इज अ चीप इट्स नॉट सो कॉस्टली तो व्हाई गवर्नमेंट डिनाय फॉर दिस बिकॉज डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन डिनाइड ना.
I think we will discuss all these things here.
I think
why they deny all these things, we better keep quiet here. We need not discuss all these things.
Yes, yes. But in Delhi, not using everywhere. मतलब इन गुजरात इट्स अ गुड बट इन दिल्ली मतलब मोस्ट ऑफ डॉक्टर्स नॉट अवेयर ऑफ दिस मेडिसिन.
I would suggest to all the doctors that please open your eyes, please open your mind, ignore the government. You just go on internet and find the relevance of methylene blue for COVID-19 treatment. You will find 48,000 papers and more than 18 lakh references and cross-references.
As so, today we are trying to convince our health minister of Maharashtra in the same way, it's a process that to convince the health minister of our country, it's a going process. We will move to the another question.
Dr. Dere, Alele Ahet Majamate. Dr. Rajesh Dere.
Haan, doctor. Haan, hai. Haan,
gya ta na.
Haan, yes.
गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग सर्वांना, एवरीवन. सी आमच्या इथे बीकेसी ला हिंदी और इंग्लिश वी एट बीकेसी आई थिंक आई विल ब्रीफ यू. हैव ट्रीटेड मोर देन 22,000 पेशंट इन लास्ट 11 मंथ. व्हाट वी हैव डन, वी हैव टू कार्डियक इंटेंसिविस्ट. We have done a sample study of 95 patients and duration of study was 4 months. Now the conclusion I will brief you. It is observed that the recovery of the patient with the administration of methylene blue in COVID-19 positive patient is more rapid. Moreover, the mortality ratio has decreased after administration of methylene blue by more than 50% in the above mentioned sample. So this is what is our conclusion, and we have complete case studies and everything.
That's excellent.
Extremely good.
So this is on 95 patient. Now we are means we are doing this observational study, and we have asked our doctors. I think from last week we have increased giving methylene blue to number of patient at BKC. So somewhere when I discussed with Rahul Madam, it is cheap and nothing harm when it doesn't have any adversity. And as such, even though at some stage remdesivir is effective or tocilizumab, which is rarely available, is only, you know, we have done tocilizumab study of more than 300-400 patients of cytokines from only in that 6 to 8 hours period as this tocilizumab is effective, otherwise it has not worked. So this is what practical experience we have, and now we are increasing number of patient on methylene blue by considering this practical experience that if you could decrease mortality by 50%, it would be a boon to the COVID treatment. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Dereji. We are Dr. Rajesh Tope was also there, our health minister, but I think he's busy in your COVID center. So Tuesday we are going there. If you can also assist us there. So we can go there to health minister and we'll give them methylene blue, and we will encourage them to encourage more people, more doctors, and to add it in the we can. And I think Dr. Ramesh Shah will also join us if it is possible.
Thank you, madam. I will review it back to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You are working hard for COVID center. I know you are always busy, but here Dr. Golwalkar is there and Dr. Kakadia ji. I am very much thankful. You have also joined us. Thank you.
Again,
anybody have some questions to Dr. Rajesh Dere? You can ask. Rajesh Dere, you wait for 5-10 minutes.
Again, I have a question on behalf of Nima. Sir, if you mind it, our government has banned or restricted the nebulization in OPD or IPD level. Then how could you use the nebulization of methylene blue?
As I described, I made some changes in the nebulizer and I'm not using mask. I made a hole in that chamber. I haven't got it right now with me. And so it comes in jet, so it doesn't cross infect. And even after that, I sterilize it with Dettol. So no question of cross infection. So if you use it in that way, using a mask, you have to use nebulizer to every patient separately. But in the way I'm using, there is no chance of any cross infection. Aerosols, yes, yes. Aerosols of methylene blue, it is methylene blue itself is toxic, means it kills the virus. So no question of spreading infection because of aerosol.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Kranti Kumar, Dr. Om Prakash.
Dr. Kranti Kumar had a question about the same. I had mentioned the legal aspect. He has mentioned that the
mute.
Why it is not recommended in ICMR guidelines?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it will be I will answer the question that it will be take care of by Dr. Shubha Rao madam and Dr. Topi sir.
Dr. Om Prakash.
Yes, yes. Sir, good evening. I'm Dr. Om Prakash. I'm a clinical microbiologist. I'm practicing in Chandrapur. My question is that we have the industrial and my laboratory is having that preparation, that is methylene blue preparation from the laboratory side. It has potassium hydroxide inclusion. So whether that preparation can be used for the routine use or not?
No.
Because this stock is out of the market now. We are not getting methylene blue injections.
No, number one, I don't think you should have any problem getting methylene blue injection because I know Gujarat stock is, they always have 5,000 injections in stock.
Mm-hmm.
So, and the company there, the three companies, the three largest companies are based in Bombay itself. You just contact Flagship Biotech, they have 10,000 injections at any moment.
Okay, okay.
So there's no reason why you would not get. Number two, as to the laboratory reagent, which is readily prepared, it may contain some amount of alcohol, KOH and some other preparations.
Yes.
Or the staining of the cells or the fungal cell in your histopathology. So that is not to be used. But the powder from which they make the methylene blue solution. So laboratory grade powder, which is available as 25 gram bottle, anhydrous powder, which is made by, there are four companies which make Glaxochem, E-Merck, Randexichem, that is Renchem, and Sigma Aldrich. So yes, these are the four companies which make the powder. So you can use that powder, which is 98% pure, use that 1 gram powder in 1 liter water and make the methylene blue yourself. But don't use that liquid, which is available as laboratory reagent.
Okay, okay, fine. Fine, thank you, sir.
Dr. Sanjay.
Namaste, sir, madam. Hello.
हाँ बोलो सर.
हाँ सर, मेरा क्वेश्चन है, हर पेशेंट का अपन G6PD नहीं कर सकते, तो फिर हम ब्लाइंडली प्रोफिलेक्टिक और थेरेपेटिक यूज कर सकते हैं
जी? रूटीन, इफ द पेशेंट इज नॉट सीरियस देन यू कैन गिव सबलिंगुअल नेबुलाइजेशन. दोज हु आर सीरियस वर ऑक्सीजन लेवल इज गोइंग डाउन, व्हेन यू हैव टू गिव इंजेक्शन ऑफ मिथिलीन ब्लू, in that condition you have to get it done, otherwise you will face some problem. But routinely, if you don't have to use methylene blue IV, then you can use sublingual nebulization. But where you have to give, you must get it ruled out by doing G6PD deficiency.
Aur sir, jo ventilator pe jo patient gaye wale, us pe iska kuch role?
ventilator mein, that's what I was saying, that I get a call, those patients were on ventilator, they we have given methylene blue, but patient is not responding. See, it will clear hypoxia within half an hour to 45 minutes, but because lungs are not in a position to supply, provide oxygen, so at the same time you have to start clearing the lung as early as possible. Otherwise, you will get response. Patient, you will be happy that oxygen level has gone up. But because lungs are not in a good position to work, give supply oxygen, so that is not suffice. That will not do the job. What we should get. And ventilator, you cannot do nebulization.
अच्छा वैक्सीन के बाद में जो एंटीबॉडीज तैयार होते हैं सर, तो उसमें इंटरफेयर होता है क्या मिथिलीन ब्लू का?
नो,
उसमें नहीं करेगा.
नो, इट डजंट इंटरफेयर विद द गामा ग्लोबुल्स.
ओके ओके ओके, थैंक यू सर.
सर, कैन यू से समथिंग व्हाट मेथड वी कैन अडॉप्ट ड्यूरिंग द वेंटिलेटर going on, because they cannot be off ventilator for nebulizer. Can we have some system by which we can have both continue, the nebulizer as well as the ventilator?
That's why I had shown that Kakre Sahib had shown very nice picture that I have started using. I am using it in oxygen as a humidifier. I am using methylene blue, so that goes along with the oxygen.
That is perfect, because that is one practical difficulty many people.
RC, that's a wonderful innovation by Dr. Golwalkar. He uses methylene blue solution straight away, undiluted. 0.1% methylene blue, about 200 ml to be filled in the bottle. So it goes continuous. And so the oxygen carries the molecules. That's a real smart invention, Dr. Golwalkar.
Daga sir, Sanjay Londe sir, and unmute karapi.
Almost all the questions from the chat box had covered. A lot of compliments are, sir. Means most of the chat box is completely filled with the compliments. They all have given lot of thanks to Golwalkar sir and Kakadia sir.
Dr. Daga sir, it is a concluding session.
There are a few doctors who have raised hands.
Hello, madam.
हाँ बोला.
हाँ question our session madam simple है, मुझे almost
all. हाँ simple है, आता हरकत नहीं, आता wind up करा
खूब. Yes yes.
Doctor Golwalkar, आपने बहुत time दिया है, 3 घंटा हो गया है, और लेकिन बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस के समाधान हो चुके हैं. डॉक्टर रमेश शाह ने भी सबको आंसर्स दिए हैं, मैंने देखे हैं. तो अभी थोड़ा वाइंड अप करिए, नहीं तो बहुत टाइम हो जाएगा.
लोंडे सर,
आई रिक्वेस्ट लोंडे सर टू प्लीज कंक्लूड द सेशन.
यस यस,
वोट ऑफ थैंक्स.
अक्रिया सर जो मेरे साथ में होते तो आधा काम तो वही कर देते.
सर थैंक यू सो मच. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Dilip Deepak Golwalkar sir. Thank you, Dr. Jagdish Kakadia sir. Dr. Ramesh Shah sir. Thank you so much for the very informative and very important talk at the point of COVID-19 situation in all over India. The very informative and very knowledgeable talk. All the doctors who have attended must have gained much knowledge about methylene blue, how to use it, when to use it, in which format to use it. Either that is in the injectable form or nebulization form or sublingual or dilution in 1 liter and use it 4 ml per day, and the way, different methods of using methylene blue in different type of stages of the diseases. So I personally, from the on behalf of NEMA Mumbai, NEMA Maharashtra and NEMA India, would like to thank Dr. Golwalkar sir, Dr. Ramesh sir and Dr. Kakadia sir. A lot of thanks to Dr. Shubha Raul ma'am, who has done a lot of effort to bring all of us under one umbrella for today's lecture. Thank you so much, Shubha ma'am. Big thanks to Dr. Rajesh Tope Bhaiya, who has given some time for our lecture, and he joined from Jalna. Despite of this COVID situation, he has given some time to us. So thank you, respectable health minister.
Thank you, Girish Daga, sir, for providing us the opportunity via Zoom link and attending the lecture and doing all the work. Entire day I have troubled you a lot, but thank you so much, sir. I would like to thank our NEMA CC president, Dr. Chemburnikar, sir, and Dr. Kulkarni, sir, who have joined this meeting from Solapur and Akola, along with many colleagues of NEMA. Dr. Bazare, sir, who is the secretary of NEMA Mumbai. Thank you so much, sir. And all the participants who have joined the meeting from the different places of India, thank you so much for joining the meeting. If at all you have any questions or any doubts, we have number of Dr. Kakadia, Dr. Ramesh Shah, or you can put it in the chat box. We will definitely give you answer. We will give the link, which today's link and the other links also for the lectures and for the uses of meeting view to you, and we will provide you a NEMA group. Once again, thank you everyone for this wonderful session. Thank you so much.
Thank you and bye-bye.
Bye. Madam Karu, conclude?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good night to everyone. Take care. Bye-bye.
Sagayanna, khub khub dhanyavad. Thank you.
Good night. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Everyone.
Oite, sir. Namaskar, sir.